Hey, what's up, guys? It's Royal Fantasy here, and today we are streaming once again. Well, I'm gonna wait for more people to come arrive. Just got to know. And public. Alrighty, there we go. What's up, everyone? Welcome to the stream today. CJ! Haha, what timing? Okay, how's the audio sound? I made some slight adjustments. I can't quite tell. If the music's too loud or not, let me know. Perfect, perfect. Discord notification game, you know what's up. Seems to be pretty good. Okay, well, if it's too loud, just let me know and I'll try and turn it down and stuff like that. What's up, guys? Perfect, awesome. Alrighty, well, I'm gonna wait a couple minutes for some more people to get on. Usually takes a minute or two, and then we'll start playing some games. What I'm doing today is we're just going to be reviewing, well, not reviewing, we're going to be playing all of the new Czechoslovakian medium tanks. For the start of this stream, I will focus on the first three vehicles, the Skoda T25, T34-100, TVP VTU. But then primarily I'm going to focus on the tanks that I think people will want. And these are the tanks I think people will be keeping in the end. TVP T50, 51, and the Skoda T50, which I personally really like. So, yeah, that's going to be what we're going to be doing today. Bethsaida, go ahead and keep watching Fishy. It's okay. Fishy deserves the views. Give him an extra thumbs up for me. Awesome. So we got 30 viewers on right now. Not too bad. I'm expecting not as many viewers because I'm doing this stream right as everyone's watching the winter season. So that's why we're going to start with the tier 6 tank first. So this is Skoda T25. And to be fair, I have not played this tank at all. So, okay, 1.5 inner clip, 3 shells in the magazine, 14 second reload, 160 alpha. Seems okay. This is going to be all like first impression gameplay. The Skoda T50 and the TVP are the only two tanks I've played on this account for the new Czech tank. So I think we got enough people. It's time to just jump right down into it for the whole start of this stream. Thank you so much. I appreciate the compliments, people. Sorry if I can't keep up with chat all the way. I'll do my best, but it's hard sometimes. Communist propaganda music. I can always expect to find you on either the video comment section or stream. Thank you for joining us today. Alrighty, so here we are. First game in the Skoda T25. I have no idea what to expect from this tank. I don't think it's going to be that bad. I've seen it. It looks like it has an okay gun. So let's see. Is this tank going to be worth the grind or not? Although, if I'm honest with you, most players are probably going to skip over, well, most serious players will probably skip over the tier 7, 8, and 6, but we'll give it a go. So, I believe this is based off of the T25, the German premium tank, so I guess not too bad of a haul, but nothing special. Alrighty, so, gosh, I have not played a Mirage in legitimate months, it feels like. It's so weird to be on a map like this nowadays. I don't know the tactics on this map anymore. Okay, that's not how you... Yeah, not bad, not bad. Okay, Gosh, I forgot how to play this map. It's been too long. It's been way too long. I remember this map at one point of time was a tier 10 map. Oh, there we go. Let's go to T50. Should be able to put a nice little shot into him. That thing has a nifty little gun, doesn't it? Should be able to put a second shot in towards him and probably a third shell. There we go. Well, yeah, this is a nice little gun, isn't it? It's not too bad. I mean, I don't think this is the most exciting tank in the game, but if you're grinding this vehicle, doesn't seem too bad, you know? Just your paper autoloader vehicle, I think. Got the PP Suck Squad in here, or sauce. Alrighty, looks like we're going to be pressuring this. Please don't pin me. Alrighty. Thank you so much, Brian on Blitz, for the donation. I really appreciate that. What do I think is the most balanced tank in tier 10, in my opinion? Gosh, that is a difficult assumption, really. There's a lot of tanks I would consider to be balanced, but mostly because they're not exceptional, I guess. That's a good way to put it. E4 seems pretty balanced, but if I'm honest with you, in the current meta, it still sometimes feels a little bit underbalanced. I would say the E5 feels balanced. It has a good combination of HP, armor, gun, but nothing that makes it OP. It's just good at everything. I think that's how you describe the E5. So, in my opinion, the E5 is probably the most balanced tier 10 in the game right now. Alrighty. And we got a T25. Okay, so back to the Czechoslovakian tanks. OP. Yeah, this thing's pretty cool. It's pretty cool. It's not too tryhard. I'm going to play one game in each vehicle, and then after that, whichever vehicle is most wanted out of the list of tanks will be the tanks I'll play the most because, well, I don't think tier 6 gameplay is that interesting. So we're just going to chase this MT-25 to Oblivion. He's going to cross down low sooner or later. I'm waiting. Where you at? Oh, don't tell me he's drowning. Can you drown on this map still? Ah, he drowned. Okay, well, that's okay. Not too bad. Just ace the TVP 50. Nice. Hello, guys. Hello. Welcome to the stream. We have 88 viewers already. That's crazy, considering I'm just playing a tier 6 at the moment. Yeah, okay. Cool. It's a solid tank. Is it something special? I don't know. I think it's definitely something people can grind out if they want to grind the whole check line. It's not going to be a tank that I would say you should skip. Now, this tank, I have no clue. T-34-100. Also have not played this tank yet, and damage per minute is pretty bad. Okay, 280 alpha, that's pretty good. 7 degrees of gun depression is decent. So it doesn't look like an awful tank. We'll give it a go. We'll see how it works. So off to the next vehicle. Let's be nice in the chat, everyone. No harsh language. I should play each tank until I ace it. I should, but I don't know. I get really bored of low tiers. I'm definitely a tier 10, tier 9 player at heart. But I wanted to show all the tanks so people who were interested to see what the lines were like would kind of get an idea of what to expect from it. Skoda T50 is very, very nice. It's still a skill rated tank, so you're still going to need skill to perform well in the Skoda T50, but trust me, it's a good tank. If you know how to make it work, it's definitely a solid vehicle. I like it a lot. We'll get to it in a few games. I'm just progressing up the tech tree right now. All right, T-44-100. Looks like you have an 8.4 second reload for 280 alpha. It's actually pretty good. So, not bad. All right, there's a T-28, shell velocity, fine. And 7 degrees of gun depression means you can actually kind of work a position like this, which is nice. Looks like there's a KV-2 over there. We're not going to want to overpoke that. I wonder if we can, though. All right, yeah, the gun on this tank's not too bad. Okay. Seems like a balanced tank, nothing too broken, but yeah. So let's see, there's a tiger, and I'm definitely not going to poke that, not with a KV-2. Heck, we might be able to put another shot in towards the KV-2, not quite. And there's a tiger P below me. So this is not a very good situation to be in. The enemy team have a bunch of heavy tanks coming in from pretty much every direction, and they also have a Hellcat and an Ox up top. Now the Hellcat and the Ox aren't that much of an issue. So if I need to, I can just back up and my team will provide me cover fire here. So I should be fine to just keep chilling up here, and auto aim's not going to let me hit that shot very easily. So I'll just wait for the KV-2 to pull up. Excelente. Oh, we got a nice fire. Yeah, this thing's solid. I like it. There's definitely, like, there's really nothing too bad about it. It has a good gun. It has okay mobility, has decent gun depression, decent armor. I would say it's a solid tank. It's a solid tank. And I'm getting yelled by a tiger, which is never fun, but we'll survive. I think we'll survive. This tiger's a 3-shot, so as long as I don't mess up any of my shots, we should be good here. There we go. 2,000 or so damage dealt. This is chill. Ah, man, playing low tiers is chill, I'm not gonna lie. You just... Wait, this tank has heat? Interesting. It does have heat. Okay. Anyways, what was I saying? I was saying this tank is just very chill to play. You don't have to try too hard. Oh, gosh, that was a bad shot. Pulled back too early. And, oh, there's Nox. Yep. Okay. Well, as huge surprise, there's the cat. Yep. It's not like you've ever seen her before. She has to show up on every stream or video that I make nowadays. Pretty sure about that. All right, this ox. I think, yeah, the ox should be a one shot for me. I think he'll probably pull forward because he'll assume he has a reload here. So it should be a pretty easy kill to pick up there. Excellente. And it's just a Yag Panther in the KV2 that's really left. So about 3,000 damage. This was a solid first game in the tank. Nothing special, but still a solid game. Nice little kill shot onto the KV2 there. And there's the Yag Panther on my left. So we're going to put a shot towards him. Got a lot of a heat shell there. Getting a little ricochet even. Pog. This thing's not bad. I'm actually pleasantly surprised. I was expecting it to be kind of like a Type 58. It's better. It's pretty solid. I like it. It's a good tank. I'm surprised. I thought this was going to be the worst tank in the line. It's actually not that bad. It really isn't that bad. Just looking through the chat. Oh, there's so much to look at. Oh, new tech trees, they're so easy to ace, man.
Hi, kitty.
Oh, man. Well, there you go. Aced it first try. I don't need to play any more games in this tank now. No, I don't. 3,500 average. All right, let's go for the TVP VTU now. Oh, wait. Let's go look through the stats for... Oh, nope. We're not looking through the stats. We're going into this blind. I have no idea what the stats are on this tank and whether or not it's good. So, yeah. Wish me luck. Also, the cat is right there. Absolutely adorable. Okay. Alrighty. Here we are. So, it is on Vineyards. That's just not too bad. Okay, I'm going to do... If you watch my, like, Sylviate Meds 101 videos, I think, like, 3 of those 4 vids, I got Vineyards, and I always did the same push, so you know exactly what I'm going to do. Oh, no, I have Engine Boost. That was... I definitely did not pay attention to equipping this tank. Alrighty. This tank has a really long gun. Looks like a Loaves gun, almost. So I'm just going to cruise down the mid over here. We're going to see if we can spot anyone crossing it towards the ruins. Gun depression on this thing is bad. Oh, that feels really bad. I don't know about this tank. We'll see. The 9.1 second reload. It's longer than the tier 7. But you do get higher alpha. Alrighty, let's see. Well, no one's been spotted up yet. So the enemy team are clearly sending tanks full into the... Oh, gosh. Well, that's not good. How to get 400 pink spike. Oh my gosh, 32% packet loss. Amazing. Alrighty, we'll still make it work. Alright, so we got a nice shot. Okay, the gun's pretty good. Alpha damage not bad. So I think it's, what, 310? Probably 310. And so the enemy team, they're going to be sending tanks through our spawn soon. The question is, how can I farm this up? I could potentially go towards Encounter Cap because they have no one there. And if they push through the town, I should be able to get a crossfire in there. You can see there's the M6 mutant already. So the issue with this tank, I think, is going to be the gun depression. Yeah, it definitely does not have top-notch gun depression. And, just looking at my options here. We got a Bulldog over in the town. Now, this tank should have really good high explosive. That shell velocity. Yikes. That's not very good, is it? And the DPM isn't much better either. So there's a TVP over here on our left. We're going to pop a nice shell into him. Okay, so it's okay. I think this tank's probably pretty average. But, I mean, the alpha damage is okay for what it is. But, oh gosh, shell velocity is not good on this. Okay, well, I'm just going to go yellow in on this tiger because he's isolated right now. Except for the T-34 covering him. But, yeah, he's isolated. Let's go push on the tiger. This is what the gun's better at. I don't think this is going to be a very good sniping vehicle. Ta-da. It is like a budget Soviet and a budget German tank combined because you have, like, that 310 alpha, I guess. Oh gosh, my game is laggy right now. This is not good. It's okay, we can make it work. And we're going to just progress over towards this T-34-2. We're going to put a nice shot in towards... Oh gosh, this gun depression is so bad. Yeah, I don't know. I don't think I'm a huge fan of this tank. Okay, I need to start paying attention to what's going on around me. Oh my gosh, their whole team is there. Amazing. Okay, well, I wasn't lagging last time I streamed, so I'm going to need to figure out the lag, because that's definitely kind of screwing me over just a little bit here. Okay, well, that works. That works. And there's a TVP right there, so I'm going to try to push out to him. Alrighty, well, Fatness Wi-Fi OP, exactly, exactly. Wargaming wanted to balance me again. So I guess they hacked into my internet or something. I don't know. It's okay. At least the stream isn't laggy. That's the important part. The stream is good. So I don't mind as long as the stream isn't like a 480p. I'll be happy with a little bit of lag myself. Good push shot. Oof. Get a nice little snap shot to M6. Yeah, this isn't going to be an ace, by the way. Just throwing it out there. I don't think this is going to be an ace tanker. Now we might be able to pick up a kill on the M6. Nope, not quite. There's like a 1 second lag on everything from when I swipe my hands across the controls to when something actually happens, which is a little annoying, but we could make things work out here. We're not doing too bad. Progress is being made. Oh gosh. Okay. Gonna put another shot towards the TVP there. Yeah, it has a good gun. It does have a good gun. I don't know. Reload. Gun depression is really what's kind of annoying me most about this tank. The gun depression does not feel good at all. What do you think? Do you think he's going to poke? I think we just push on him. He's probably isolated. So we're going to go for the push on in on the TVP VTU. And to be honest, I don't really want to play more games in this tank. It's not bad. It's just the gun depression is... it doesn't feel comfortable playing it. It's like a huge profile with no gun depression. Going to put a shot towards this defender. Take his tracks off. Excelente. And come on, defender. You know you want that juicer. And we're going to put a shot into his tracks again. I have to remember, he has like 200 alpha, I believe, or something. So like, I should not poke him too much. What is it? Wait, no, it's 170. Heh, I thought the alpha was more than it was. It's actually 170. It's 175. All right, not bad. And that's how you drive into a wall. Excellent. Alrighty, well, it's an okay tank. If you are thinking of going down for the TVP VTU, it's certainly grindable. It's not awful. I think it's probably better than something like an Indian Panzer and maybe somewhat comparable to a Panther 2. But if I'm honest with you, it's not a tank I'm personally going to buy on my account and play, to be fair. I'm just going to skip over this one. The tier 6 is great. The tier 7 is surprisingly good. This one, I think it's just... I don't know what the gun depression is. Let me check, actually. 6 degrees. Okay, I thought so. Yeah, the gun depression just felt pretty subpar on this tank, especially considering how tall the hull is and the fact that you don't have any like turret armor. It just makes it a little weird to play, but it's not bad. It's just not something I would say it's really amazing. That's the best way to put it. Alrighty, so here's what we all are actually here for. Ta-da! The tier 9 Škoda T50 and a TVP T50 51. Škoda T50, well, I keep forgetting. Gonna show the stats first for anyone who doesn't know what these tanks are like. This is a good tank. It has okay armor. You know, the armor isn't spectacular, but you're not playing these tanks for armor. Concealment's decent. DPM is about 2600. Not bad. Now, what makes this tank great is you have a 2.5 second interclip with 3 shells in the magazine of 310 alpha. And pretty much that's it. 8 degrees of gun depression. Definitely workable. And 60 kilometer an hour top speed. So it's very mobile as well. Now, fun fact about the TVP, or not the TV, the Škoda T50, if you did not know this, is... it is the only tank in this entire tech tree that has spaced armor along the side. So if you have tried shooting HE at the side of a Sheridan, you know exactly what I am talking about. It is the type of tank where you shoot HE at the side that looks perfectly great and it just doesn't pen. It doesn't do anything but splash damage. Same kind of deal. I have absolutely no idea why Wargaming decided it would be a great idea to put spaced armor on a tier 9 medium tank like this. But there you go. That is just what Wargaming does. Okay, so Škoda T50, this is a pretty pog tank. I'm really enjoying. This is the one I'm currently grinding on my own account, actually. And I really enjoy it. And wow, thank you so much, Coconut, for tipping $3.33 to the channel. Really appreciate the support. Alrighty, so how's the ping? We're still running about 150. It's okay. We will make this work. We will make this work. Alrighty. So this Himmelsdorf is top tier matchup. They have a pat and a Škoda T50 and a cent. And oh gosh, my game is very much laggy. Okay, 1 second. All right. So Skoda T50 went in his rails. No one spotted crossing just yet, so he could be isolated. They have tanks onto D already. So something tells me this Skoda is already quite isolated, which means he should be a pretty easy kill if he overextends. Never mind, there's a scent over here. But we can definitely put some shots in towards the scent. So there's one shell into the scent. We're going to take his tracks off to keep him in place. And we're going to put a nice second shell into him there as well. A 2-for-3 trade, not too bad. I have an M46 Pan with me, and if this Skoda and Pan push up, I need this dude to take some of the shots. Now, unfortunately, we have a bit of a numerical disadvantage here, which, yeah, this is not very good. We're not going to win this engagement at all. We're going to put a shot in towards the Pan here, and maybe if he pulls back again, we can put another shot in towards him, but I'm not going to really try and take the fight over here. We're not going to win at all, so I'm going to pull back from here. We still have tanks like this T26 E4 Super Pershing, so I'm going to run away from the enemy Skoda here, and you know what? We're going to take the clip from him. There's nothing I can really do about that, and eventually I'm going to run away, but for now, we're going to just chase this Skoda. Wow, okay, rear armor galore on this tank, and apparently it's not HEable in the rear either. All right, well, good to know. Okay, I'm just going to run away from this dude, and gosh, my driving right now is not good. And we'll get safe with the K91. The K91 should be able to provide me the cover fire I need here to get away from this fight safely. Hopefully our team can kill the E75 and the ST1. Pan is now shooting at me, which is not very pog, but I'm going to push up with our team here. So that wasn't great. Our Pan kind of just YOLO'd there. Alrighty, so is it just me and this Moishin? It is just me and this Moishin. I don't know where the whole team is then. Okay, E75 and ST1 both just fired, so I'm going to take advantage of that. We're going to pull around the ST1 here, putting one shell into his tank here. We're going to pop a second shell in towards his tank, and we're even going to pop a third shell. You can see the clip on this tank is very good. It's a very solid clip, but you definitely get ripped apart very easily in this tank. We've already dealt 3,000 damage, so, you know, not a bad result all in all, considering just how kind of this game was overall. But yeah, okay. So, let's see if we can get one more clip in before this game is over. ST1's bound to be right around the corner. Managed to debate the shot out of the ST1. We're going to put a nice shot through his lower plate there. We're going to put a second shell in. We're bound to have tanks coming in from behind us soon. We're going to take his tracks off, hopefully. And maybe we can just get around his side here. So, nah, we're going to die. It's okay. We still did roughly 4,000 or so damage, I believe. So, not bad. Sometimes your teams just aren't good. It's whatever. Not bad. I think the lag at the start really threw me off a little bit there, but it's fine. We'll get over it. Yeah, it's a good tank. I really like this tank. So yeah, about 3,900 damage first game. We're going to try another one in it. My goal is to play at least one battle in every tank till I win them, and then I'll play the most requested of these Czechoslovakian tanks after that. But yeah, the clip on this thing is really nice. It's like a better tier 9 Batcha. I think that's a good way to put it. Also, because, you know. Oh, okay. Hello. What's up, guys? Okay, I should try catching up on chat right now. Hey, kitty. Please don't step in front of the camera. Here, you can just stay there. Exactly. Good job. Alrighty, second game, here we are. We are on Yukon. This is it's a pretty big open map, so I think there's definitely a lot of options for us here. Enemy team have a standard B, pretty good counter to my tank, two T49s and a TVP VTU. Very interesting. I have a Pan with me, T49. So I'm not going to commit to the corner. The enemy team do have superior medium tank numbers, which means if they commit all their tanks towards this corner, they'll theoretically win that fight. So I'm not going to take that fight outright, but I will sit back with our T49, who's going to spot everyone up apparently, like a Chad he is. Okay, we're going to put an HE shell into this T49. Now, if you didn't know, the TVP has... Oh gosh, I'm getting such awful pink spikes right now. These new tanks have really good high explosive shells. So if you did not know about that, definitely take advantage of the HE. You're going to do about 400 plus every shot. We've already done 1100 damage with that first clip, so not a bad start. And this is why I didn't overcommit to the corner. You can see our M48 Pan. He's probably going to get ripped apart by the Chieftain. He's probably going to get stuck in a crossfire with the T49s. It's just not a great situation to be in. And considering that my internet is not giving me the best shots right now due to ping, I think we're going to try and not take snipe shots. So we're going to put one shot into the AMX. We're able to put a second shot into the AMX there. That's where that 2.5 interclip is nice. Patton's getting rushed. He does have a waffle covering him, so, or Borsig, I should say. Not quite the same. Hey, kitty. All right, standard B took the corner. What's that mean? So TVP VTU is up top over here. We're going to try and pop some shells into his tank there. Now someone else gets spotted below me. It's a T-49, but instead I'm going to clip out this TVP VTU. He is one clip after all. M6 picks up the kill, and now I gotta watch out for tanks on that corner. There's no reason for me to really stick here that much longer. I think I'll be more useful to my team if I can pick up a kill on some of these isolated tanks over here. So this T-49 is about a two-shot with high explosive, so I'm going to take advantage of that and try and push onto him and maybe pick up a kill. I don't know. Is the Chieftain progressing? No, the Chieftain isn't progressing. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna pick up a kill on these two tanks over here. We're going to stay a little bit away from the main engagement there and just really hopefully get a nice kill onto the AMX first. He is more dangerous after all. Looks like he is on a clip though. And I'm going to keep an eye out for that T-49. Not quite able to get a shot onto him. And even though we're not theoretically winning this, our team isn't doing as bad as it looks. We really aren't doing that bad. So we're going to push in on the T-49. I think I'm going to ignore the VKB here, and we're going to just clip out one of these T-49s here. We're going to put one shell into him. And heck, oh wait. You know, this is not a very good idea, come to think of it. There's a standard B there as well. We just big brained ourselves. Okay, everyone just missed me. We're fine. Everyone just missed. And the Chieftain's not paying attention. Excellent. All right. So if the Chieftain's not paying attention, the T-49's just miss. We should be able to put a nice shot into the T-49 here. We should be able to put a nice kill shot into this T-49. We kind of big brained there for a moment with our YOLO, but we did manage to recover. Don't do that, though. This isn't a tank where you can just YOLO into a crossfire like that. Yeah, very, very, very big brain. Very big brain. Alrighty. Looks like a VKB is preoccupied. I think I'm going to go for the VKB. He is the more dangerous tank here, and hopefully he's not looking at me. That's kind of the goal. We don't want him to look at me. Gosh, that was a bad shot. And we're going to load up the heat shells, putting one heat shell through his lower plate, and then an AP shell for 4,200 damage. So you can see, this tank just performs really, really well. It's solid. I mean, there's really no other way of putting it. A solid 4K for both of these games. And even though we lost the first game, it doesn't matter what tank I was in. We're pretty much going to lose that anyway. So, Mastery First Class, not too bad. And of course, now for the exciting tank on the game. Oh, Meezy, what's up? Time, we need to add another moderator. Thank you, Meezy, so much for joining the stream today. I really appreciate it. It's good to see you here. Perfect. All right. So TVP T-51, I believe is the name. This tank is very interesting and very difficult to play. That's a great way of placing it. Now, the reason it's difficult is you have, oh gosh, what's the reload? You have a 21 second reload. Now, I've heard a lot of people complain like, well, the Skoda T-50 has better DPM. It has shorter reload. It actually has the exact same DPM pretty much as the Skoda T-50. So theoretically, their DPM is similar. The way it releases its DPM is just a little bit different, but it's really nice. That 2 second interclip reload for 4 shells with 310 alpha, 60 kilometer top speed. I am really enjoying this tank right now. And to be honest, I think it is, I don't think it's the best tier 10 medium just because it's going to be very difficult for a lot of people to play. If you are a little bit too aggressive, you make a little bit too much of an overplay in certain areas, you're going to get absolutely ripped apart by the enemy team. So, Skoda T-50, we are on Port Bay for this first map. The enemy team has a Sheridan and E-50M. I have a 62A as an ally. Now, the question is, do we take the corner? Well, this is a map where taking the corner is something that you would expect of the medium tanks. The question is it the big brain play to make this game? And intuition tells me it's not. Because just looking at what our team is doing right now, you can see we have an E5 going town, we have an E57 going town. As much as I'd love to go corner here, it's really not a good idea. Not with how my team's playing. In fact, I'm going to just go all the way into town. There's no reason for me to sit here. They'll crossfire us out from the corner. It's unlikely they're going to send a ton of tanks into town themselves, so I could probably pull somewhere in towards their spawn and start clipping the enemy team out from there. At least that's going to be the plan. Heck, we might even be able to get a shot on towards this 57. Get a nice shell into the 57 heavy there, and we won't be able to get more shots. Now, we are spotted. We'll have to watch out for that, but the VK90 might be able to give me a shot there as well. So that's 2 shots to start the game. Not too bad. But definitely not fully utilizing the clip there. Now, the VK has rotated back, and I just need to decide how I want to play this out. I think I'm going to support our E5 here. He's pretty isolated, but I can provide good cover fire from where I am, but I'm not going to push up as far as him. As you can see, the E5 is already getting ripped apart, and my tank's driving itself, which is great. There we go. And, okay, so there's the 183. Yeah, you know what? I take that back. I'm not going to support the E5. The E5 just pretty much, he's just dead already. That's going to be a waste of my time. All right. So we're gonna drive back the other way. I guess this is a great example of how good the mobility is on this tank, because you can legitimately drive in circles and perform just fine. I'm going to ignore this flank right now. You can see the Sheridan has really kind of overextended in the enemy spawn, so we're going to go back and see if we cannot pick up a kill on that Sheridan and E50M, because our Yag and 62A are trying to hold them off over here, but they don't have a ton of support, so I'm going to go back this way. And my priority for the start of this game, oh well, the Sheridan just lost all of his hit points anyways. We're going to try and put a nice kill shot. Okay, we bounced off the Sheridan, that's fine. We're going to put a kill shot in towards the Sheridan here. Looks like there's an E50M up top there, and the I7 has over-aggressed down low. Now, R57 has YOLO'd, and that's another heavy tank pretty much down, which is very unfortunate. But we might be able to get some shots in on this I7 here. I7 manages to just pull out in time. Good for him. And looks like the E50M is pulling back as well. So we're going to load up a heat shell here for the E50M, putting one shell in towards his tank. We're going to pop a second shell in. Not quite able to pen that. And yeah, this is just an awful, awful matchup because, you know, mines be doing what it wants to do. Not mines. Port Bay is such an imbalanced map on this spawn, especially when you have teammates YOLOing into town with their E5s. Oh well, I digress. We're going to now rotate back for the Yag Panzer E100 and the VK9. Actually, you know what? The Yag's pretty much dead to the IS-4. I can one clip. Oh gosh, you know what? We're gonna go for the 57. He's a much more deadly tank. We're gonna put one shell into him. We're gonna put two shells into him. And if we manage to max roll our third shell here, we should be able to pick up the kill. And the max roll crew skill gets activated. That's what I love so much about the TVP T50. You have that max roll crew perk, and what that does is it gives you a good chance of rolling above 1300 with an entire clip very easily. And it came in handy there because the 57 had 330 HP. He was above a one-shot for me, but we were able to pick up the full clip on him just because our crew skill was able to work well for us there. So VK90 is all that's left for me to deal with here. We're going to pick up a nice kill on his tank momentarily, making good use of the clip there, and it's just me and the Yag Panzer E100. Now, the E50M's a very difficult opponent, and he's in a great position. So, how are we going to take this fight? Well, I'm the one with the hit points here. I have 1500, definitely can deal with the E50. I think what I'm going to do is, I don't know if I can cross here safely. We're going to try and cross down safely over here. And then we're going to try and pressure the E50M. Now, I'm not going to go from this side because the Yag won't have shots, right? The Yag's my only teammate. He's the only one that's going to provide me the cover fire. What I need to do here is try and really create an angle where the E50 will have to overextend the push onto me, right? Because the Yag can provide me cover fire. And the E50M, I'm sure, is in the corner somewhere over here. Unless he ran away. Did he run away? Oh, where'd the E50M go? Oh, he ran away. Big brain. Okay. Oh, no, he's by the Yag. I thought he was... No, maybe he went for the Yag, or did he go through the river? Ah, he did go for the Yag. Okay. I wasn't paying attention. I thought he was in the corner. Turns out he actually went for the Yag. Please don't die, Yag. I really need this Yag to stay alive just for a little longer. All right, time to yellow into the 50M. Ta-da! And here is where this killer clip potential... Okay, well, that was a really bad start to the clip. There we go. Oh, wow. Okay, yeah, we're going to track him twice. That's fine. There we go. That one actually deals damage. Not sure how the first two didn't actually deal damage there. So two shots into him. I'm going to tell the Yag to hold position here. I can just push in and very easily pick up a kill on the E50M here. Doesn't have a ton of support. I am a roughly two shot, though. I'm going to have to watch out for that. So we're going to kind of act like we're pulling down below the E50M here, and then we're just going to pull back here. We're going to pull forward once again, and we should be able to, with ease, pick up a nice little clip kill on the E50M here, who is pretty much stuck in the open. And that's where that clip is nice and satisfying. Very solid first game in the TVP T50-51. I think probably my favorite part about the game is when we big brained on the 57, and then we asked RNG to give us a max roll, and we max roll. I know it's a new tank, but that is pretty low experience for an ace tanker. Okay, first time ace tanker in the TVP as well. Not too bad at all. What's up, Shock? Thank you for joining the stream as well. What's up, RGK? Alrighty, nice. That was a spicy first game in the TVP. I think we go again for the TVP. I think most people are here for TVP and Skoda T50. So those are the tanks I'll play the most, unless I have like a ton of people requesting for T34-100. I don't know why they would, but if a lot of people request those tanks, I will play them. For now, we're going to keep with the top two, though. What's up, guys? Thank you, everyone, for joining the stream, and thank you for everyone who's liked the stream. I believe we already have 126 likes, which is great. Maybe we can reach 150 in the next few minutes. If y'all smash that like button, that'd be appreciated. And, yeah, so, Her Royal Panzer. Interesting. We have a semi-copycat name on the enemy team. Okay, it's Dynasty Pearl, and if I'm honest with you, this is not my favorite map for the TVP. The TVP is a weird, fickle creature. It's not a hold-down medium tank, and you don't want to play it like a hold-down medium tank. In reality, I've personally found the TVP to work quite well in town environments, especially if you just wait for the enemy team to kind of overextend. It can be really nice. So we have a TVP on the enemy team right in front of us. Now, fun fact, TVP's hatch is based armor, so you actually can't pen it. Oh god, I don't know what's going on. Ah, I'm lagging. That's not good. Okay, I'm gonna pull back from there. That wasn't very pog. No, that was not good at all. Okay, we're going to wait for our clip to reload here. And I think we have a numerical advantage here. Well, wait. Everyone's kind of clustered in this corner, so nothing's really getting spotted up. As far as I'm aware, they could have a bunch of TDs right behind the TVP. Intuition tells me otherwise. I think the TVP is isolated, so we're going to push in on this TVP. All right, yeah. TVP is indeed isolated. We're going to load up high explosive here. We're going to put one HE round into it for 360. We're going to put another round into his tank there. We're going to put a third round into his tank there. And we're going to put a fourth round into him for almost 1300 clip. That is why this tank can be so nasty, is you just find those isolated targets like so, you just dump a clip. This is very much in line with the clip and dip playstyle that I've always talked about, where it's just you find an area to clip, smash the vehicle, and then you just pull back. Now, I might end up having to kill the TVP here because no one else wants to shoot at him, so I'm going to be the one that picks up a kill on this TVP. That's fine. I don't mind doing that because it's going to help our team in the long run. And looks like there's an ST1 here. Now, what's on encounter cap? All right, there's the ST1. Oh, that's a 183. Okay, we're not going to poke the 183, but we can put some shells in towards the ST1. They're putting two shots into him for 720. He gets a nice shell to me, and I think our team's got this. So I don't know what the HP the IS4 is. Thank you so much, Thomas XQR, for the 333 donation. Really appreciate the support you're providing for the channel. All right. And hello. Hello. You said hello, so I'll say hello back. Okay, so what I'm going to do here, there's the ST1. We're going to try to put a shell into his tank there. Oh, I have to reset the cap in a moment. We can still do that. I can kill the ST1 and reset the cap still. That's fine, because I have three shells in the clip right now. The ST1's giving me rear shots. So we're going to put a one shell into the ST1. Should be able to very easily pick up a kill shot there. And let's see if we can reset the 183 at all. No. Oh, wait. The 183 pulled back. All right. Well, we're going to lose this to cap, I think. That is a big rip. I thought I would have the time to get there and to reset. Lol. All right. I guess kudos to the 183. He capped out there. Big brain. He big brained on our whole team there. I should have just gone for the cap defense. Sag. Oh, we still did 3k. Okay, I don't know. This lag is really annoying me. Give me 1 second. I'm going to just check my internet connection, but I'm going to turn this off. 1 second. Don't worry. I'm still here. I just need to real quickly do some quick checkerunos because I don't like playing with lag. It's not very fun. I guess I can read chat while I wait. Yes, it's a big rip that the enemy team capped out there. Oh, we got the spam. Excellent. All right, and let's do a quick internet speed check just to make sure this is the fastest network for me. Sorry, guys. I guess you get to enjoy just looking at me right now. Hey, that's not too bad. It's not the greatest. Okay, well, we'll give it a go. Maybe this network will be a little less laggy. We'll see. All right. And we're back. We're back. Welcome. Yeah, Fatness Wi-Fi is struck today. The question is, though, I mean, the good news is the stream is smooth. We haven't had any lag to the stream today, and I'm at least happy about that. Give you guys a quality streaming experience. Alrighty, let's give the TVP another go, shall we? Okay. TVP stream. Yes, TVP stream or Skoda T50 stream or any Czechoslovakian medium stream. I covered all of the tanks kind of at the start, played a game in each, and now I'm just kind of playing the ones that I'm most interested in. The one I think you guys are most interested in. Now, if you have a preference on which vehicle from the tech tree you really, really want to see, then go ahead and say in the chat, and if enough people say they want said vehicle, then I'll happily swap out and play that tank. As long as it's part of the new Czechoslovakian medium tanks. Okay, so our ping is a little better. It looks like it's about 50. No packet loss as of yet, so hopefully this goes better. All right, so we are on Black Goldville. Sheesh, I'm not a huge fan of this map for the TVP. The main issue I have with a map like this is you have to be hauled out in pretty much every environment you go to, and this tank just doesn't work hauled out. Now, you can see we have a lot of heavies going town, so what I'm going to do here is just kind of spot up the mid. Now, I'm a little too slow to spot much, but we might figure out where a few tanks are going, and interestingly enough, there's a TVP and a 62A yellowing down the mid here. So interesting, yeah. So 62A is turning kind of around. I don't know if he's actually going to push on me or not, but these tanks are really overexposed, and if my team can push onto them, that would be good. So here's the TVP. I'm just going to sit back here. He actually gets a good shot into me. And hopefully if our Skoda provides the right amount of cover fire here, we will be fine. So the Skoda is coming back to provide the support I need here. And this should be good. This should be good. So the 183 absolutely nukes the TVP there. And it's going to be my goal to clip out this TVP. So we're going to put one shot into the TVP. We're going to keep pulling around the 62. We're going to put a second shot into the TVP. We're going to put the kill shot in the TVP. And that's where that clipping potential is. It's really nice. Also, great work to the Skoda on the target prioritization there. Focusing the more dangerous target. Good teammate. And now we can just continue. Now, I think my internet's better. Aha, I just had to swap networks. Okay, I can make that work. So most of the enemy team's up top. 62A is all that's left. And you can see our Skoda T50 is actually going to reload faster than me. And that's where having that just better kind of clip reload time is going to be very beneficial for him. He's actually able to get more shots into the 62A. Now, oh wow, 62A actually sneaked level 1000. Okay, there we go. I was going to say, no way the 62A made it out of their life. Alrighty, what do we do from here on? Well, our 183 is going to get pressured. My goal should be to cover the 183 here. I think that will definitely work pretty well for me. So that's exactly what I'm going to do. We're going to go back. The K91 is going to be overexposed here. I'm going to clip out. Now I'm only going to clip for a few more seconds, about 7 more seconds, and then we should be able to easily pick up a kill onto vehicles like this K91 here. K91 has fired twice, so we're going to put one shot into his lower plate, and here's where that clip is just so nice. No, we screwed it up though by shooting his tracks. Okay, well that's a little unlucky. We're going to take his tracks off again maybe. Not quite able to kill him there, but hopefully the 57 will be able to do some work. 183 does a good job there, and where are those TDs at? Okay, so 268's above. I don't know where the Waffenträger is. Oh, yo, the Kron just fell. Oh, no, wait, the Kron can back up. No, he can't back up from there. Excellent. Okay. Well, here's where I push onto the Kron. So please, I'm sorry if I block you, 57. I'm not trying to. Just trying to get past onto the Kron. We're going to put one shot into the Kron here. We're going to put a second shell into the Kron here. We're going to put a third shell into the Kron, and we should be able to pick up the kill just like that. You can see the clip on this thing is very nice. You just have to be cautious when you're playing it. Don't just YOLO into every environment and just be like, I can YOLO, I'm awesome. Definitely don't do what this Waffenträger is doing. Waffenträger. Oh, Waffenträger. Oh, Waffenträger. What have you done? You have come to be HE'd. And I cannot, can we get an F in the chat for this Waffenträger? He's about to experience what a TVP's HE clip can do. 1400 damage with 3 shells. Adios, my friend. You fought hard. Oh, poor Waffenträger. Alrighty. This is great. I love this tank. It just has such a chill, laid-back playstyle. You know, you just kind of float around and find those targets that push in, overextend, clip them out, and just hit repeat. That's really all this tank is. So, looks like our K91 is hopefully going to pick up a kill on the 268 here with the ISA as well. My team should have this win. We're going to put one shot into the ISA. We're going to put a second shot into the ISA. Should be able to pick up the kill on him, and we'll be able to put a second shot in towards this E75 and just pull away from him as well. K91 will clip out the E75. The ISA will put a shot onto him. And to be honest, by the time I reload my clip, this ISA's probably going to be dead. So, actually, I might be able to get 1 or 2 more shots into him. Not a bad game. Not a bad game at all. I think we can do close to 6k by the time this game's over if I reload in time. And we're still reloading. Excellent. All right. One shot into the E75. We're going to put a second shot into him. There we go. 6,200 damage. Great game. Another quintessential example of just how to play the TVP. You just float around with your team. That's something that's important to note. What you saw is I didn't push caves. Ordinarily, I like to take my tanks to the caves, but not there. Obviously, with your team going town, it's a much better idea to go up towards mid, where your team can provide that crossfire there. And as the 62A and TVP, they thought they were going to big brain and push down the river or down the highway. They weren't quite able to accomplish that, unfortunately, though, because my whole team was right there, and they all kind of got distracted by me. So that worked well. All right, so Faust, we're going to play a third game in the TVP, and then I think we'll take the Skoda out next. It's a pretty solid stream so far, I would say. The enemy team that was shared in the TVP, a T-54, E1, and a WZ-120. These are all solid vehicles, and they're probably going to go to the corner. Now, the great thing is, really, they don't have effective turrets, and sure, the WZ has an okay turret armor profile, but something you need to keep track of in something like a WZ-120 is the fact that it has absolutely no gun depression. Good shot by the Sheridan, I guess. Wow, I did not expect him to hit that. Oh, he penned me through my mantlet. Pog. Okay, well, That's how you lose a good chunk of your HP. Still, we did 3 shots there. Not too bad. There's a 54 below us. Our whole team is here. We don't have to worry too much about what's going on right now. And I just love this tank. I don't know. There's just something about its playstyle that is just very enjoyable. It's hard to explain. All right, T54 is now getting pressured. I did wait till he'd get distracted before putting the clips into him because I don't want to take extra damage here. I've already taken a pretty good amount of damage at the start of this game, so we managed to get a nice clip into him. Very easily able to pick up the kill there. And we pull back into cover. And then just wait for the enemy team to give us more shots of opportunity. This tank is just, in a nutshell, so potentially... Oh, gosh. Oh, no. 183 got himself hit by the E3. No, I wanted to nuke the one... Not the 183. The Gorilla 15 got nuked. Oh, no. The Gorilla 15 got double nuked there. Oh, gosh. Poor Gorilla 15. Okay, Sheridan's all that's left here. I'm going to focus the Sheridan here. He's a more dangerous target to me. He's much more mobile than a T95. So, able to put a third shot in. Maybe we can even pick up a kill there. Excellent. We managed to get a nice little kill on towards the Sheridan as well. Putting a nice full clip into him, and we continue the progression onwards. I mean, this is just a solid tank. It's solid. It's not like super complicated. You just have to play it cautiously. And if you play it cautiously, it's very easy to do well in this vehicle. So here's a WZ120. I don't think we'll be able to HEM, so we're gonna put an AP shell into him. We can HEM, so we should be able to finish him off with like 2 or 3 more shots here easily. Put another shot into him, and Leopard picks up the kill. I'm going to save my final shot for the 183 with a 20 second clip reload. There's no way I'm getting into this time. Oh yeah, well the 183 is a one shot anyways, so this works. Please, I want to pick up the kill. Excellent, 50 damage. Another solid game. I mean, come on. What's there to really hate about this vehicle? No, I am not. Damage farm maintenance deactivated. Yes. Yeah, I will take the man bun down for 20,000 subscribers. We'll have the full length hair reveal, but you'll have to wait till we reach 20k for that. So I don't know. Recommend me to a friend so you can get to that 20k mark sooner. When can we see Smasher gameplay? Next time I play a challenger/tank request stream, I think we'll be good to do that. Definitely. All right, so back in the Skoda T50 tier 9 matchup, it's Yamato Harbor. And what did the enemy team have? Well, they have a T49, a Skoda T50. That's it for the medium tanks. A bunch of nasty little TDs, but I think we got this. I think this shouldn't be too bad. Oh, Meiji's still here. Epic. Not even ace. Pfft. I know, right, Meiji? It's such a disappointment. And here is the 047. We're going to try to put a shot in towards his hatch there. Gun handling did manage to hold up pretty well. Oh, gosh, T49. Well, T49 tried to HE me there, and I guess that's a great example to show what I was talking about earlier. HE, riding to the side, was not able to pen because of... Spaced armor, Wargaming's big braining spaced armor program. So looks like there's a TVP over here. We're going to pull away from him. We do kick con fire there. I don't want to get stuck in the crossfire, and the enemy team clearly have kind of a numerical advantage over here. So what I have to do here is just pull away. I don't want to abandon this fight, but if you look at just what the team is layout is like, and considering what the Skoda T50 is like, I'm going to snipe at the start of this. I'm going to snipe for kind of like the rest of this game. Not a ton, just a little bit, just to get some shots in here and there without overcommitting, because the moment I overcommit to either of these flanks, it's going to be very easy for me to get killed. Now, we should be able to put 2 shots in towards the IS-8. 047 does manage to put a shell into us, I believe, and we should be safe from the Scorpion for now. And, well, no, actually, I think that was a TVP that hit me there. We'll just sit back for a moment. Oh, no, it wasn't. Maybe it was the IS-8. I don't know what hit me for 310. And looks like there's a Fosh up there. So I definitely will rotate out soon. I'm just going to see if I can get a shot on this Fosh. I think the Fosh is pulling forward. What do you think? Yeah, that shot definitely went in. Let's put another shell in just in case. And I'm going to pull out from this location now because our Moishin's dead. Our whole team's stuck in town. I can't hold here any longer, really. So there's no point in me going and fighting over here. Now, what our team could be doing right now is clearing this a mill 2 because the mill 2 is pretty isolated. And if they could clear the enemy spawn, that'd be great. But we need our T95 and our Mil 1 and our M103 to take some shots here, because they're the only tanks on the team left with hit points, so it's really important that they do take some shots in progressing with this fight. The Mil 1 has pulled forward here, and I don't want to overextend here. We're not even going to hit 2 shots here. Only hit 1. Yeah, and of course, TVP is poking around the corner. We're going to put another shot into him there. All right, well, this team is not very POG. I don't know why everyone went town, but it's an F in the chat. So, yeah, this game probably not going to win this one. I'm thinking, no. Not with the amount of HP they have. Oh, and there's the TVP. We're going to put 1 more shot into this TVP. We're going to kind of side scrape out over here. And I think he has a 3rd shot on the clip. So we're going to put... Oh, we managed to track him there. Excellent. And here's where we just run away from him. Oh no, there's an Ice 8. I don't know. There's nothing you can do about this game. Our whole team just sat in town. That's kind of a rip in the chat. Oh well. It was a worthy try. I think we go back to the TVP. I didn't play that the smoothest, if I'm honest. I just don't know what I could have done there. The enemy team, they won the right hand side. His Royal Fantasy summoned thy accident one Bobby. She's sitting right here. Here you go. There you go. There's the cat. Yeah, see? She's saying hello. Oh dear. That was kind of a rip. I did not play that well. But back to the TVP. T5051. We are on Alpenstadt. This is a pretty solid. It's a solid map. I'm not a huge fan of the map, but I think we can make it work. I'm just going to spot up the crossing. I'm not going to commit to the corner just yet. I don't like committing. Not when they have a 183 E3 YAG and a bunch of meds. I should be able to outspot anyone that's crossing to the corner, though. So that's what I'm going to try and do for the start of this game. And there we go. We find the 183. We should be able to put at least two shots into him. So one, we're going to put two shots into him. We are spotted here. We're going to put three shots in. I'm not going to poke for the fourth shot because the 183 now has the angle on me. But still, we were able to put three shells into there very easily. That's a good start to the game. So we're just going to hold back for now. And oh yeah, there goes the 183. So the standard B was the medium tank that shot at me and spotted me. That's interesting. Now I'm going to pull back just a little bit. You can see that our STB has managed to pull forward here. Yag Tiger spotted me up. Got to watch out for that. And I am getting shot by the standard B. Our whole team is coming this direction. So I'm going to use this E100 as kind of a meat shield. You know, you can take the shots for me. There we go. Okay. There's the Progetto. So we now know where the Progetto is as well. They're going to put a track shot into the Progetto there. Might even be able to put a second shot into the Progetto. Heck, we might even be able to put a third shot into the Progetto. And let's put a fourth shot into the Progetto. So, yeah, full clip into the Progetto in exchange for one shell. I dig it. That is a really solid trade. So, not too bad. Not too bad. I'll see you later, Raj. Thank you so much for showing by to the stream. Alrighty. So, what are we going to do from here? Well, there's a Yag Tiger over in town. Now, the Yag Tiger has a really good reload, and I don't know if I'm spotted. I'm going to wait till I see him fire. Once he fires, I'm going to dump a clip into him. I just have to wait for him to get distracted or fire. So, Yag Tiger is not looking. You can see, so we're going to pop one shell into him. He has just fired, so we're going to pop two shells into him. We might be able to pop a third shell into him, and we should be able to pop a fourth shell into him. And that's just being patient, right? If I poked forward while the Yag was looking at me, he would have put a shot into me, and I guarantee he would not have given me that full clip there as easily. So, just be patient in this vehicle. It's all about just taking the fights and taking the positioning that'll get you the best damage. There's a TVP down here, down below us. We have a Waffenträger and a 183 up top here. E3 is down low as well. Question is, will we be able to clip out this TVP? Now, the TVP is a little bit exposed here, and I don't think he can push on me. Not with the Waffenträger. Where's the 183 at? Oh god, our TF5 got lit up though. Well, the issue is I'm very easy one clip range for the TVP. He just has to put three shells into me to one clip me here. And that's what's concerning me the most. But he's giving me a side. We're going to put a 525 max roll HE into the side of his tank. Another H. Two shots for 1,000 damage. Come on. That HE is just like god tier. Oh, that was very satisfying. Okay, standard B, E3, and Progetto are all one shots. This Chieftain Mark 6 is the only tank on the enemy team with hit points left. And something tells me he is going to be giving me some good shots soon. Of course, there's the Progetto. I'm going to wait till I have a clip loaded up, and then we're going to push forward onto maybe the Chieftain. I think the Chieftain's going to progress forward here. We're going to put one shot into the Chieftain. We're going to put two shells into the Chieftain. Should be able to put a third shot. Oh, not quite able to hit the third shell there, unfortunately. Maybe we can hit a fourth shell. We're going to load up a heat round. Not quite able to hit that one. It's okay. Chieftain is still very healthy right now. And I'm just going to wait. Yeah, okay, yeah, Progetto has gone down. Standard B is now going to distract the enemy team. And here we can just push in on the Chieftain. Actually ricocheting a shot off the back of our tracks there. Excellent. And we're going to YOLO, 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 YOLO because we want to farm damage with our TVP and get to 5k plus this battle because this was a pretty solid game so far. So Chieftain Mark 6, all that's left. We're going to pop one shell into him. And we're going to pop two shells into him, taking his tracks off there. We're going to pop a third shell into him. And we're going to pop a high explosive shell into him to finish him off. Or Waffle Trigger Amaraxim. Another solid game. Well, I mean, I'm just digging the TVP right now. This tank is so good. 5,800 damage, another ace tanker in the tank. Solid, solid. Unfortunately, we lost the Skoda game, but I mean, somehow I still did top damage, and I played that pretty bad. Let's give the Skoda another try. Okay, very good. I hope everyone that's watching this video stream right now that are interested in the TVP and don't have it, or they're going to get it, hopefully this is helpful. Hopefully you get an idea of just how well this tank can perform if you just play it right. Patience, definitely 100% based on how you locate yourself and just dumping that clip. It works so well. Same thing for the Skoda T50, in fact. This thing does a good job as well. Alrighty, back to the Skoda T50 and Vineyards. Enemy team have a Skoda, a P-44 Pantera, Panzer 58 Mutz, a Shark, and my team have more heavies. Now, how are we going to play this? Usually what I like to do is push into the ruins, but I think given... Yeah, I'm going to push ruins. I'm still going to push ruins. So we have a T-34, we have both TDs. I'm not going to push all the way into the ruins, but you know, if you watch my videos, you know exactly where I'm going. I'm going to try and spot up the enemy team here, and I'm just going to pray that whatever goes to Cap B and whatever goes to ruins or towards, the, yeah, ruins will be able to provide me the support I need here. Now, we should be able to get some shots in towards tanks like the Panzer 58 Mutz, getting a nice shell into his tank there. We should be able to get a second shot into his tank there, and heck, we might even be able to get a third shell, ricocheting the third one. Still, not a bad start to the game. Now, if I get pushed on here, theoretically, the Waffenträger, the mill, the YAG, all of these tanks will have cover fire on me, so I'm pretty safe where I am, and I don't have to be too worried about getting YOLO rushed here. And I think I definitely made the right play in going this way, because if I went in counter cap fighting those heavy tanks, it's just not very POG. So yeah, okay, let's see. TVP is a two shot. It's going to be my new goal to try and pick up a kill on his tank here. I'm gonna put one shot into the TVP here. We're gonna load up a second shell, pick up a nice little kill on his tank, and I believe the Mutz just fired at us. Not quite able to wing the third shell in there, but we got map control already. So now that the TVP is flushed out, I can go back to originally where I was gonna go. I can pull back up towards the mid here and clip out those heavy tanks in the rear, because poggers, heavy tanks are juicer, and it's fun to clip them out. What can I say? All right. So we got a P-44. I'm going to go for the P-44 first, actually, because he is the more mobile tank here. God, we're going to lose a lot of hit points here. It's okay. There we go. We'll take the trades. We're distracting the enemy team. Not the biggest brain trade, if I'm honest with you. I should have just clipped out the tortoise's hatch. Would not have had to expose myself so much. But it doesn't matter. I think we're still going to do fine here. Okay, there's the Panzer 58 Mutz. Now that the Panzer 58 Mutz has progressed forward, he is still within one clip range, right? And so what I can do here is I can now push on the Mutz. So I'm definitely dividing my attention wherever I think I'm going to be most useful. Now that the Mutz is all the way aggressive, we're going to put one track shot into him. He gets taken out there by my ally, which is great. And now we can push up and start farming the tanks over an encounter cap very, very easily. So let's see. What is this? Are we able to HE any of these tanks here? And nope, we are not. I'm going to go for the E6, though. He is the lower HP target, or the Shark, the T-54 Shark. I'm going to put two shells into him. And then we're just going to casually cat the base, because... What else am I going to do for 16 seconds? So we're going to cap the base. And still a solid game. We should still do about 3,000 plus damage this battle by the time it's over, I believe. And there is the Emil. Can't quite HE pen him, but we're going to put one shot into his turret there. We're going to put a second shell into his tank there. And heck, we might even be able to put a third shell into his tank there. Excellent. I knew the Shark was going to die to our TDs, so I didn't really worry too much about him. And all that's left is the Tortoise and the IS-6, who are both really low HP. And we're just going to dive bomb onto a Tortoise, because that's fun, right? That's always fun. Yeah, dive bombing two Tortoises is fun. Oh, Waffenträger isn't quite able to pen, or Borsig isn't quite able to pen his HE there. We're going to put a shot in towards this dude. And now it's just the IS-6. Who is YOLOing over top here, getting a kill picked up on, and hello, Action X. Solid game, about 4,500 or so damage. Not quite 5k shock. I wish it was 5k, but I wasn't able to get a full clip in there. 4.4. We were two shots away from 5k. There we go. Redemption in the Skoda T50. And back to my favorite TVP. It was almost 5k. It was almost 5k. Dun, 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 dun. All right, I am not looking through this chat. Hey, Zeus, thank you for showing up. I remember seeing you earlier today. I appreciate you showing up for the stream. Alrighty, so we're on Rockfield, and enemy team have a Progetto, a 62A, Vickers T92, and a Vickers CR. Yeah, they have a very mobile lineup, and on a map like Rockfield, that is very good. Okay, so this is going to be a little bit more of a cautious game. The enemy team are super mobile, so no matter where I go, I could get countered just by their team composition. But we should be able to get at least one shot. We should be able to get at least two shots into the T92 here, and maybe even a shot into the 62A there as well. Excelente. And if this T92 pulls forward even more, we should be able to put a third shell into his tank. I'm just going to wait for him to potentially pull forward. Come on, you can do it. I believe, my brother. I believe. Oh, he's so close to pulling forward. I don't know. Do we do it or not? And not quite able to snap it. It's okay. Not a bad start to the game. We got 900 off the bat. And I'm just going to wait to see what these TDs do. Now, I can see the TI-5 is over here. I'm not sure where the Gorilla 15 is, but I'm going to assume he's probably in the generic TD spot. Now, we have a huge overmatch on this side. And the question is, can we take advantage of that overmatch? Now, I don't want to abandon our TDs, but I really can't do much now in the corner. So let's load up a heat clip here. I'm just going to start clipping out this T95. We're going to put one shot. We're going to put two shells into him. We're going to try and put a shot. Ah, God, that was a bad clip on my part. I'm not even going to bother shooting another shell. We're going to need to reload there. All right, TI2 is running away. It looks like the Vickers and Progetto are both stuck in the mid. TI5 is about to get himself killed. And Progetto gets absolutely whacked by our TDs. Okay, not bad. I'm going to hold here, and I should theoretically be able to farm this Vickers in just a moment. We're just going to wait for him to pull forward a little bit more. So Vickers is now pulling forward. We're going to pop one shell into the Vickers here. We're going to pop a second shell into the Vickers there. Not too bad. 62A is going to pull forward next. We're going to pop one shell into the 62A as well. And maybe even two shots into the 62A. Not quite able to hit the fourth shell. All right. So there is the Vickers CR up top. Oh. I see a grill. Yes, I do see a grill. And I know, I sound very excited right now, but it's a grill. And you can HE a grill for 1600. So, grill, please don't YOLO. Please don't YOLO, grill. No, don't YOLO. Girl, stop it. Stop it. I want to HE you for 1600. We're not going to get the 1600 HE clip. Still, we'll get a nice HE onto the Rearest tank. We're going to put one shot in, two shots in. We should be able to put a third shot in before the Vickers picks up the kill there. Excellent. And it is just the Progetto. Do you think we can HE the Progetto? Ha! 525 max roll. Why not? All right, not too bad. Wow, that was 4K damage? That did not feel like a 4K damage game. I don't know, man. 62A is going to be my next victim here, I think. We're definitely going to want to farm him out. Him and the Vickers both are going to be the last tanks left in this game. And of course, the tanks that I will want to farm the most. I'm going to act like I'm on a reload to the Vickers. And then we're just going to kind of push in on him and easily pick up a quick and easy kill onto his nice little British light tank. Easily done. 4.7K damage. Maybe we can get one more shot in towards the T62A if we are lucky. We're aiming for it. We're going to aim for it. We're going to pick up a kill shot. Ah, not quite. Almost 5K again. Not quite. It was close. I don't think we did. We got like 4.8 maybe. I don't know. Do we have a fire? Yeah, 4,860. Another ace tanker. Apparently this tank isn't too hard to ace right now. So if you need to spam some aces, this is the tank to do it in. Oh, wow. David, thank you so much for the donation. Why RGN didn't participate into winter tournament? We didn't feel like it, to be honest. Yeah, we just did not feel like really doing the whole tournament thing this time around. You know, we spent a lot of time on the autumn season tournament. We won that, and we just wanted to take a break. So that's what we're doing. So just chilling, it's actually really fun, if I'm honest, to watch the tournament unfold from a viewer perspective, not from someone who's actually playing, just someone who's just watching the tournament for what it is. It's very interesting. All right, so we're in the TVP once again, big surprise, and we're on Yukon now. The enemy team, they have a Progetto, Batchat, and that's it. Okay, so Batchat and me, enemy team have a Progetto and Batchat. I think I'm going to go up towards the mid by D and just try and get some early spots in and try and figure out, well, let's see where we can farm up best. So that's exactly what I'm going to do here. All right, there is the Batchat, and we're going to... Oh, please give me the clip. No, he's not going to give me the clip. He's making the right decision of running away there, and I don't want to overpoke this, not with a Ho-Ri that could be sniping around the corner there. That just wouldn't be very big brain of me, and I can't quite clip out the Batchat. Now, they have tanks on B, which is good, and as of right now, our Batchat hasn't spotted anyone up, so I'm going to assume they... there we go. That's exactly why I didn't want to overpoke that bush earlier. I'm sorry our Batchat had to be the one to experience the HE, but there you go. That's why I did not over poke on this side, because of those TDs. And I'm very happy I did not. So yeah, I'm going to pull out from here. We're going to go help our heavy tanks. You can see we have a bunch of heavy tanks on B as I just pinged on the map. And really just no need for me to fight a Chieftain, an E3, a Progetto, and a Ho-Ri. That's just not going to go very well. So I'm going to get all the way out of here and try and see if I can help the horde of heavy tanks we have on B cap right now and try and farm up as much damage as possible while we can. Fatness, he has long hair. Indeed, I do have long hair. Big surprise. And for 20k subs, I will reveal thy long hair. All right, there we go. Maybe we can Amrak the ST1 here if we're lucky. I'm gonna put another shot into him. Should be able to put an easy kill shot into his lower plate. Excellent. Able to get the clip there that I was looking for. And with all of our heavy tanks over here, we should be in a pretty chill position. Now, that is a Progetto 65. We're just gonna pull away from him. And we should be able to bait him into the rest of my team here, which is fine. You can see there's a 57 coming behind for the Progetto. And perfect. So the Progetto has now overexposed himself. And he's running away. That's fine. Now, if our 57 is clipping, the Progetto would want to kill him, right? Right? So theoretically, I should be able to get some great shots in towards this Progetto here. So we're gonna put two shots, we're gonna put three shots, we're gonna put a nice third shell into him, and heck, we'll put a fourth shell. That's another clip. Now there's gonna be a Bat Chat on my left. We're gonna watch out for that, and there he is, as I predicted. And we're going to just pull back from the Bat Chat. Now the Bat Chat's going to clip. He's going to clip our 57, and he's going to try and run away. So what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to YOLO into the Bat Chat, because the Bat Chat's clipping, right, for about 16 seconds, so I should reload him 10 seconds before he does. And he's an easy one clip for me, so we're going to try and just do that. Now, he's a little bit faster, which is a little annoying. I'm going to put one shell into his tank there, but he does run into our whole team, manages to pick up a kill. And I think that's one of the nice things about a TVP is you can really punish people in their light tanks that get a little bit too aggressive, a little sloppy. They overextend a little bit. And because this tank goes 60, you pop that engine boost, the Bat Chat wasn't able to escape us there. And the Bat Chat's probably was one of the best clippers in tier 10 before. It still is. The Bat Chat still has its thing but going. But that's just where having like that 1,000 plus every single time clip potential is just so nice on a tank like this. Now, this game is actually pretty close still, so we're going to load up the heat rounds. So you're going to put one heat shell into the E3, and we're going to put another heat shell. I'm just going to very thoroughly aim those shots. I don't want to bounce any of those shells there. And it's just a Chieftain Mark 6 left to pick up a kill on. Don't think we farmed a ton of damage this game, but it was still a decent battle. It was still a pretty decent battle in the TVP. Fannis, I don't mean to be rude, but can you end stream? It's 4 a.m. I need to sleep. Oh, meaty. Another ace? What's, why? 1,300 basic speed and ace in this tank. Oh gosh, I'm gonna have more aces. I'm gonna have like an almost equal ace bar now. Yeah, BZ, I think you're gonna be awake for a few more hours. I'm sorry to do this to you. Imagine sleeping, BZ. I go to sleep at 9 a.m. these days. Yeah, Shock, your sleep schedule's really messed up, mate. Really, it really is messed up. All right. We're just gonna keep playing the TVP because my god, I am enjoying this tank right now. And I'm not playing it like a complete Muppet, which is good, right? It makes me feel better. Also, camera angles. There you go. Alrighty. So we're on Nubay. What I'm going to do here is figure out what's coming up this side. Well, that's a lot of tanks coming up this side. And it's also a lot of tanks I don't want to fight, but you can see my whole team is coming this way. So at least we have that kind of benefit. I don't think I'm going to need to run away. Going to wait till someone overexposes, aka this 1-2-1. One shot into the 1-2-1. Let's aim for a track shot here, maybe. Not quite able to hit it. All right, well, still, we got two shots into the 1-2-1, and I'm just going to reload my clip now. Now, the question is, what do we do from here? Because this isn't really the gameplay that suits the TVP. Now, I can't really pull back easily, not with the E100 creaming down this way, but eventually, oh, I see an opportunity here soon. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to climb up the mid here. So I think all the TDs have been spotted up, right? The Gorilla 15 is still kind of an oddity. I don't know exactly where he is. And our Fosh just got hit for 700. That had to be the Gorilla. Oh, that was a Yag. Okay. I think the Yag spotted me. I don't think he did. All right, one shot into the Yagaroo. We're going to put two shots into the Yagaroo. We're going to put three shots into the Yagaroo. And we're going to put four shots into the Yagaroo. Excellent. That's exactly what I was looking for. A good solid clip into the Yag. Now, the question is, I have to kill this Yag before I can progress on this flank. Because you can see what happened to our poor Fosh and 215B there. But I'm going to need to kill this Yag quickly. So what's the best approach I can take to killing this Yag? I think this way is actually the best because I can use these bushes to my advantage. As you can see, the Yag is spotted. I'm going to put one shot into him. If he tries pulling forward, you can put a second shell, pick up the kill there. And we were just using those trees as cover. That's why I was able to casually just hold there. And now we have an opportunity to shoot another tank. It's called the Gorilla 15. He's isolated in the enemy spawn. He is easily a one clip for me. So I'm just going to pressure forward onto his vehicle that is just kind of stuck in the open here. And heck, we should be able to easily get around towards the side of his vehicle here. Gonna load up the high explosive, put one HE into his tank. We should be able to finish him off with three shells here very easily. 1, 2, 3. And we're gonna pop a shell into the 183 as well. He's pretty dangerous. So that's another shot in towards the 183. 183 is probably gonna panic and push forward because he doesn't know I just killed the grill. Yep. And that should leave me free to farm another clip into the E100. And that should put us over 4,500 or so damage. So once again, this is going to be a pretty decent game. Alrighty. 183 is first. We got to prioritize our targets here. I would love to damage farm an E100, but this 183 is just way more deadly of a target, and I'd much rather pick up a kill on his tank there. So I'm going to put one. We're going to put two. He gets taken out. Excelente. And now it is just this E100 here who is about to get clipped by 4,005. So 4,005, make some room, please. Alrighty, we're going to put a shot right through. Oh, no. Just shoot heat. Okay, well, rip the 4.5k dream. We're stuck at 4.2 now. F in the chat. I like this guy. You. Oh, Meezy. Thank you so much for joining the stream today. I know it's pretty late. Pretty early for you. Or late. Well, I guess really, really, really late. Really late or really early. One of the two. All right, time to push the 100. I'll take the shot from him because he's about to go down anyways. And 239. Still, we did 4,500. The mission was accomplished. Another solid game in the vehicle. By the way, we have 240 likes. Thank you to everyone who has been smashing that like button. Really appreciate the work. And, you know, I'm not even going to act shocked anymore when I start acing the TVP because, to be fair, no one owns the tank. So we're just going to leave it there. Let's play another game of the Skoda. Let's give the 29 some attention for everyone who is grinding for this beautiful vehicle. But yeah, so if anyone is interested in my opinion on these tanks, I really like them, and if you know what you're doing, you're gonna perform well. But they're not easy. They're definitely not easy tanks to play. So easy to just overextend on a corner or try playing haul down, and you just get absolutely ripped apart so fast in this vehicle. So just be cautious of that. Otherwise, the tank is really solid. Alrighty, or the whole line is really. Yeah, except the tier 8. I still dislike the tier 8. I think the tier 8's kind of trash. Habib, hello. Thank you for joining the stream. Who is better, Watea or me? I think Watea. He's bigger brain. Have I been streaming for 69 minutes? I did not know that. Well, there you go. Alrighty, so we are on Desert Sands. Enemy team have a Leopard 1, Indian T-34-3, and it is me as well as a Centurion and a T-92. Now, T-34-3 is being super aggressive, and as you can see, the Leopard has abandoned him. In other words, we're gonna clip this boy out, and there's nothing he can do about it. So, time to yell on up behind the T-34-3 here. I wonder if we can HE him. We can. Okay, one HE shell for the win. Then we're gonna pop some AP shells into his tank as well, putting an AP shell in there as well, and then another AP shell, and hopefully my teammates will push up and provide the support I need here. Oh man, I really didn't want to take an extra shot from this dude. He's gonna get an extra shot in. Come on, Sent, kill him! You got him in the end. It's okay. Okay. Not a bad start. I guess we got a full clip in, but we did lose half our HP to a T-34, which is, kind of sucks, but we'll make it work. Alrighty, enemy team are pretty aggressive in town. I don't know where the T-95 is. I assume he's slightly farther back. Yeah, there's the T-95. Okay, that's good to know. We're just going to pull away from him. I don't want to take a fight from a frontally from a T-95. Now, if my medium tank's pushed in here, I'll just wait till the T-95 shoots, and then we'll just put like a heat clip into his lower plate or flank him. Right now, there's really no pressure in me to push on this T-95 until he shoots, because once he shoots and gets distracted, it's easy going from there. Oh, you know what? This T-95 is just completely distracted. He can't even shoot me here. I'm just going to ignore him, and we're going to pick up a kill on the Indian Panzer instead. I think that's probably a bigger brain play here. We're going to pick up a kill on the much lower tank health target that definitely needs to die. So we're going to put two shots into him. We're going to put a third shell into him. Excelente. T-95 is still distracted there, so we can just keep farming up these tanks. I mean, this is just target prioritization. The T-95 can't do anything, right? Not in the crossfire he's in. He's just stuck here. So we can definitely take advantage of the fact that they have this tank destroyer completely out of the fight and just utilize it to farm the enemy team. Now, I'm going to load up the high explosive here, and we're going to try and clip out the AMX 5100. He is a more dangerous tank because of the clipping status. We're going to put one high explosive shell in. He gets taken out there. Excelente. And we're going to put a nice shell in towards this WZ as well. T-95 is still distracted, and WZ is now progressing forward onto me. Really wants that kill, doesn't he? We're going to keep backing up here. Does get a shot into me. That's fine. I can take the shell there. And our team's definitely winning this big time. I don't think we're doing 4K this game, though. It is of the big sad. We are not doing 4K this time, sadly. Going to put another shot into the WZ. Going to wait till he gets distracted, maybe. As he is right now, we're going to put another shot into the WZ. Wow, talk about low rolls. And WZ gets taken out. And I'm going to save my final shot for the T-95, who is giving me his rear. So maybe if we're lucky, we'll get an HE high roll and pick up that kill. So not bad, not bad. Alrighty. Oh no, T-92 made him turn right into me. Very big Sag. Alright, get to his side, get a nice shot into him. And that's about 3.7k damage. Not bad, not bad. I'll take that. I'll take that. It's a solid game. Which auto-aim version do you use? I use the old auto-aim 100%. I do not recommend new auto-aim. It is way too invasive. It does everything for you, and it makes your aim more sloppy, in my opinion. And of course, if tanks are moving around a building, it just like leads the shell into the build. It's really bad. I don't like new auto-aim. I remember when new auto-aim was first introduced, it was during Mobile Masters 2018. Right before Mobile Masters 2018, and everyone had to play on brand new auto aim that were auto aim players. It was not fun, but we got used to it. I know, right, Meezy? Not even 4K. What am I? This is garbage level gameplay from me. Alrighty. All right, let's jump into another game with the Skoda T50. It is Castilla. Love this map. I usually perform quite well in it. Enemy team, they have a T49 and a TVP VTU. Yeah, nothing I'm too scared of to play against right now. So what I'm going to do here is... Yeah, I'm going to go towards the Castilla Hill. Definitely can work down that alleyway. And hopefully, my goal is to kind of spot up their tank destroyers, if that is possible. And we'll use that information to really... hopefully get their TDs nuked. And we have gotten a donation, $25 from Smoky Scotch. Thank you so much for the donation, and cheers to you as well. Alrighty. Thank you for the support, everyone. Really appreciate it. By the way, what do you think about the little notification bar that I was working on today? It's nothing special, but it's progress. I'm starting to feel like an actual streamer now. It's amazing. we'll get a better donation bar soon. we'll improve it. But for now, I'm pretty happy. It's simple and straightforward, and it gets your attention. Alrighty, so spotted none of the TDs here just yet. T49 is making a break for it. Tells me he doesn't have a ton of support here. So I'm going to push up top and try and see if I can spot the TDs from a little bit more of a direct route. And we'll just do our best from here and see what we can do. So... no TD spotted up just yet. Aha, there's the 704. Okay, 704 gets baited into shooting at me. We're going to take his tracks off once. We're going to wait till he uses his repair kit. Come on, you have a repair kit. We know you're going to use it. And okay, he's not going to use it. Whatever. Okay, so three shots into the 704. Great start. The reason I knew their tanks were not over here is that T49 was making a break for it. He did not want to stay here, and he would not do that if he had support by his whole team. So that's why I just YOLO'd in at that point. So let's go keep pushing forward here. Then you'll push up to the Kalabana position. And oh, juicy. Is that a VTU? I don't know if I can HE the rear of his tank, but intuition tells me I can. Oh, I should have just YOLO'd into him. I could have clipped him out. Now the AMX 5100 is going to clip him out instead. This is very big sad. We'll still be able to farm some shells into him, I'm sure. So we're just going to push forward onto this TVP VTU here. He is pretty isolated. So we're going to pop one shell into the rear of his tank there. I'm going to save my shot, and there's the T49 over there. We're going to pop... oh, no! Bad shot by me. All right, TVP thinks he's fine. We're going to pop the kill on him. Excelente. And there's a Lova pushing forward. So... there's the Hori. Okay, Hori's just sitting back. I think we can clip this Lova soon. What do you think? We can drop into the ditch with, like, this 252U, and this Lova's gonna have a miserable day. I mean, he's getting dropped down by three tanks here. My poor man's. Oh, no, everyone's getting a roadblock. Massive roadblock! Ugh! I can't pull around. I can't farm. No! It's okay. All right, we'll go for the E75 then instead. All right, we're gonna need heat the Penum. Interesting. Okay, one heat shell, and that's a second heat shell into him. 325. Low actually hits me, and he kills my loader! No! Okay. So the low is about to go down, the 75 is about to go down. I think this T49 is going to be my goal. We're going to clip out the T49. Let's get some revenge. Also, this is an RAP. I think this is going to be my first sub-3K game since New Bay in this tank. Sad. Okay, hello T49, come here! Come here! Come here, little dude. Come here. Yeah, come here. TVP is coming for you, boy. Fill it up an HE for him. 1 HE, and 2 HE, and AP for the kill shot. Excellent, excellent. Not a bad game. Oh, we did 3.3. It was sub 4K though. Hello, Economics Mate. Thank you so much for joining the stream. Appreciate seeing you around here. Look at all these mods we got in the chat. Ah, I feel proud of myself. Got so many mods on today. Excellent. All right, so some spicy games in the TVP, and sorry, not the Skoda T50. Oh, gosh. Now we're going to play the TVP. All right. Oh, I like this map. Okay. This is one of my favorite maps in the game, in fact. Okay, so we are on Oasis Palms enemy team. They only have a T55A for mediums. We win the medium fight, but they also have an E5 and an IS-4. So those are very solid heavy tanks. A Badger could come dunes. So as much as I want to just YOLO rush into C, I still need to take this a little bit intelligently, because if we take a look at their lineup, they have a very good C lineup. In fact, we have a much better town lineup than C lineup. So what I'm going to do here initially is try and get an early spot off, maybe an early clip to start the battle, but I'm not going to commit fully to the dunes for the entire game, right? We're just going here for the initial spot slash shots. There's the T55A, that's fine. My main goal here is just to spot whatever's coming from the left-hand side, if anything is coming from the left-hand side. Now, as you can see, no one has been spotted crossing to the corner, that's great, and their heavy tanks have been spotted. Now, I'm not going to peek up all the way. I think I need to wait till my camouflage is reset. And will I have shots on the IS-4? We will. So we're going to put one shot into the IS-4 there. Ah, the IS-4 debated me. No, he's big braining. Okay, we're going to... oh, no. Accuracy. Okay, hopefully third shot goes in. Oh, okay, well, two shots. Not too bad. Not too bad for the start of this game. So they've sent no in the C. I got big brained on. I thought they were going to send a lot of tanks here. They didn't, but that's fine by me because that means I get free farm on their spawn. And once those TDs get spotted up, we know exactly where they'll be. Oh my gosh, the E5 gets nuked. Now that is an E75 over there. T55A shouldn't be able to spot me, and we should be able to easily just farm out this E75. We're gonna aim for some track shots, maybe. Not quite able to hit the tracks there. Oh no, we didn't deal damage though, but we did get the tracks at least. Another three shots in there, not bad. Now they probably have TDs right around here, which is why I'm not just pushing in just yet. In fact, where's that T55A at? If that T55A is in the mid, I'm going to go clip him out because he'll be an easy clip for me where he is, right? He's kind of stuck in the middle and I don't have to expose myself to the TDs, right? So we are spotted. I might get Gorilla 15 here, which wouldn't be good. And we do get Gorilla 15. I expected that, but at least I get to put a full clip in towards the T55A. I think that's not a bad trade. To be honest, I think that's a good trade. We got the pesky medium tank to 390 HP now, so not bad. And we're just casually farming up in the dunes over here. And I think my team's still doing okay in the town. I mean, they're not doing amazing, but they should be able to hold there for a little longer. And, oh boy, it's a badger's rear and juicer farm. I'm going to wait till he gives me a track shot. Not able to hit the tracks there. There we go. Okay, we didn't even damage the tracks. Excellent. And we should be able to finish him off just like that. Excellent. That's where that 2.0 inner clip is so spicy, because you just clip the tanks out so easily. There's the Gorilla 15. And I think y'all know what I want to do this game. You may think I'm going for the Gorilla 15, but what you all really want to see right now is me take my tier 10 medium tank and one clip out a tier 9 TD. I think that sounds like fun, doesn't it? So that's what we're going to try to do now. Here's the Waffenträger. I'm going to activate that engine boost. I'm going to not get myself spotted until the last minute, and 1 HE, and we're going to pull back, and we're going to put a 2 HE into him, and we're going to put a 3 HE into him, and we should be able to easily pick up that kill. All right, you know what? Oh god, that was a bad trade. Okay, IS-4 is more dangerous. We're going to pick up a kill in the IS-4. But we did almost one-clip the Waffenträger. Unfortunately, target prioritization. Oh no, my team is throwing. That wasn't actually very big brain. I lost so much HP there instead of picking up the kills. Sad. I wanted to go for the HE. That wasn't very big brain. There's the Waffenträger at least. My driver's out for 60 seconds. Ah, that's not good. Alrighty. Our E100. Everyone on the enemy team is really low HP. We're gonna put kill shot in towards the E75 there. At least that one does go in. And I don't know where this Waffenträger is. There's the Waffenträger. We can probably keep backing up away from him. And we're able to put... Oh, no! No! Bad aim by my part. Oh, well. We did our best. All right. Don't be too damage greedy, my guys. I should have just picked up the kill on the one shots there. I think I easily would have won that if I just killed the E75 and the IS-4 first. I just did not realize my team was doing so poorly there. Still aced it, though. Still got the ace, but I threw that game. That was my bad. Oops. Oh, Juicy! What's up, Juicy? I'm a wave to you. Thank you so much for joining the stream. And we got 300 plus viewers. Excellent. 283 likes. Can we reach 300 likes before the stream's over? You guys know what to do. Okay. So, well, don't like my gameplay because that last game wasn't like worthy for sure. I became too greedy. Alrighty. So, Dynasty's... No, not Dynasty's Pearl. It is Dead Rail. And looking at the lineup, enemy team, 62A and E50M. I think we can deal with these tanks. Is that a VK-72 coming up top? Interesting. Okay, so VK-72 is sniping. There's the E50M. We're going to put a shot into him to start the game off. And we know where the VK is. Interesting. Okay, there's also an E75 that has shots on me. I'm not going to overcommit here. Now, one thing you'll notice right off the bat is I don't have much support. Sure, I have a 1-to-1 with me, but other than that, my whole team's gone left. So we're going to be careful here. I'm not going to overcommit. I'm going to wait to see where the majority of the enemy team is before I really commit somewhere. Okay, so now we know where the YAG is. That's helpful. In E75, YAG, VK-72 is out of the fight, kind of. Do we actually have shots on the YAG? Not quite. Oh, that's a 62A. Okay. So we are now spotted by the 62A. I don't know. We're safe from the YAG. We're safe from their TDs here. If I can bait one of their mediums into me... Now, I think the 4005 is going to be cover fire in the E50M. That's the biggest issue I have with this game. Is E50M's very likely got support from the 4005 here. We're going to put one shot into the E50M there at least. And looks like our bat chat's going balls deep. So we're going to go in. Yeah. Batchat just doesn't want to. He's not going to just chill there. Yeah, okay. So we got some shots into the Batchat. We're going to track the 62A. Excellent. We're going to put another shot into the 62A as well. Good job, Batchat, initiating the push there. And that's why if you have a full team of 50, 60, mid 60%, high 60%ers on your team, quite often your team will still lose because it becomes a huge kind of like a stalemate. The only reason our team pushed when we did there is because the Batchat just YOLO'd in. And he did a really good job. So kudos to the Batchat. But we need players like that in the game or games will never progress. Alrighty, so 4005 is going to be the first tank on my list here. Should be able to use this rail car as cover from the VK-72 and be able to put a nice clip into the 4005 here, who's kind of stuck where he is. Alright, well, the 4005 wanted to hide from me. That's a Jagdpanzer. Not very big brain, is it? Alright, so VK-72 is right around the corner. We're just going to clip him out instead. So that's one shot into the VK. That's two shots into the VK. That's a third shot into the VK. I am spamming heat here, but we're still going to do a super good amount of clip damage to his vehicle there. Not too bad, not too bad. Alrighty. And, E-75. Oh, no. E-75 is getting killed. Rip, I'm not going to farm that E-75. He's going to die before I can farm him. That's unfortunate. I think here's why I just YOLO. Who cares if I take a shot from the Yag? That Emil 2 is going to be my target. I want to see if I can get behind the Emil and put a nice HE clip into him. Let's go for the damage, boys. Let's do it. Hopefully the Yag doesn't turn around for me. Or the Emil. Oh no, the Emil is kind of turning around. That's unfortunate. We're going to put one shot. We're going to put two shots into the Emil. Emil gets taken out there. And it's just the Jaegeru that's left. And the Jaeger is, of course, looking at me. We're going to pop one shell into his lower plate there. And we're going to just pull around the Yag, putting another shell into his tank there for about 4K. Not quite. 3,800 or so. Not a bad game. Solid. I'm digging this tank. I'm really digging this tank. I don't know. Yeah. Well, let's see. How are we doing the Skoda? 3,400. Well, let's get that Skoda average up a little bit. Not that it matters. This is a press account. No one cares about averages on a press account. Communist propaganda music. Were you in a platoon? If you're in a platoon, queue times are long. Also, if you're playing the same control mode on, queue times are really long. And if you're not playing with Supremacy and Encounter both on, queue times are really long. If you're on the NA server, in other words, you just turn everything on and same control mode off and you'll get games very quickly. That's just how it works. Hey, what's up, Forever Noob? How is you doing today? Thank you for joining the stream. I appreciate it. Alrighty. So, it is mines. I'm not going to take the hill. The enemy team have much faster tanks. I'm going to see if I can clip anyone taking the hill. Though, so we're going to put a shot into this TI-2. We're going to put two shots into the TI-2 and not quite able to put a third shell in. But he lost all of his hit points there in a couple of seconds. So that really wasn't too bad of a trade there. TI-2 is going to pull out to try and put a shot into me. We do match the ricochet. Charioteer, please just get off my side. Thank you. Alrighty, T-34 has just fired. That's all I needed to wait for. 252U might be able to get a shell into me. Hopefully not. Excellent. And now I'm in a safe position. I really needed to get out of where I was. They have hill control. They have a bunch of tanks holding mid. And all I need to do is just chill out and let our TDs get baited. Or bait them into our TDs. That's probably the best option for me right now. Now, as I am a clipper, and as I do not have DPM, I definitely can't push into their spawn. It's just too difficult, and this is why Mines is such a trash map, and it really doesn't belong in tier 9 or 10 or 8 anymore, but I digress. Can't do anything to a 252U because, you know, that tank has better armor profile than some tier 10 heavy tanks, and looks like there's a 1390 behind us. Now, that is interesting. Okay, HE, yeah, 440 into the 1390. Maybe we could put another HE shell into his tank there. No, 91. Oh, gosh, a little too greedy. Hitting him for 447 for our second shot. I was trying to one-clip him there. Almost. If I had penned my second HE shell, that would have been a one-clip. Watch for the 252U there. Excellent. When you're on mines in a situation like this, oftentimes the best thing you can do is just play a patient game. Because being, well, overly aggressive, it gets you killed pretty fast. So the patient game is definitely what you have to do on this map. Now, RT-49 should have the AMX, excellent. And the 252U is now playing very aggressive up top here. 252U has just fired. We're gonna put one shot towards his tank. Not quite able to hit him there. And T-34 is also over here. Now there's the Charioteer. We're gonna put a shot towards his tank. He does get a good shot into us, but I mean, I have to give credit to the Charioteer. He's frontlining in a Charioteer on mines. Mad props to you, my dude, but it's not going to work very well. Not from his position. He should be where the 252U is. That's a much better spot to play mines on. Alrighty, Waffenträger is only TD the enemy team still have remaining unspotted. I want to clip him out because, you know, HE. And since we have a T-49 over here, now I feel comfortable kind of pushing behind the enemy team. I blatantly refused to push behind the enemy team when I was alone. But now that I have a T-49 that will happily take some of these shots for me. Ah, 252 spaced armor. Love it. Oh no, that was a bad shot. What am I doing? We should be able to get... gosh, didn't even get a full clip in. T-34, please don't shoot me. That's just... that wouldn't be very nice. Okay, well, we can just keep holding there. 0 out of 3, not the best clip. Good news is, if these heavy tanks turn around for me, as they certainly will, they're going to get pushed on from the front, and it's going to be game over for the enemy team. Now, I could make an aggressive... now, there's a waffle that could pull into that bush, but I think I will provide more value to my team if I manage to pick up some of these kills. So we're going to pick up one shot into the charioteer, we're going to pick up a kill onto the charioteer, and we're going to put a shot into the teeth... oh, we're going to bounce off the T-34 as well. And now I got to pull back, because that waffle is going to poke from my left. As I anticipated, there is the Waffenträger, so we're just going to sit back. I'm going to knock down this tree a little bit here, and just kind of chill out. Now, I don't think he has a shot on me. He should not. Not very easily, at least. All right. Question is, can we keep backing up at all from the Waffenträger? I think we can. That wasn't very big. Oh, no, we got spotted. Okay, we're safe now. We're safe. We are safe. Ish. Safe-ish. Come on, stop. Please don't block me. There we go. Maybe we can get a shot into the 252U. Aha! One heat shell into him. Bouncing off his side, because why not? And another bounce, because why not? 252U has balanced armor profile. Alrighty. I'm just going to pull down a little bit here. We're just going to hug this mid-hill. That should provide me the cover from the 252U, and momentarily I should be able to get farm in on the T-34. So, yeah, this wasn't a very good game by me. I don't think I played it that well, if I'm honest with you, but we're still going to win this battle in the end. Now, I'm spotted, aren't I? Excellent. Just what I want. Okay. We're just going to keep holding here then. T-34 is, in fact, looking at me now. There we go. We bedded his shot. If our Tiger could push the hill, that'd be great, but oh, gosh. This is just not good. Because I have a T-34 looking at me. I have a Waffenträger looking at me, kind of. I can't really push anywhere, and our team's just YOLOing here. And this is why heavy tanks are broken, because they can stay alive for so long. Luckily, our VK is somehow still alive. That's an accomplishment. And, 252 is now pulling forward. Of course, another shot into his flat side, because why not? Another shot into his flat side, because why not? I mean, come on. If that isn't blatantly the most broken tier 8 in the game, I don't know what isn't. At least armor-wise. There's nothing you can do. Like, I'm aiming for his tracks underneath his spaced armor, and the shots are just bouncing and bouncing and bouncing. Now, I need to kill this Waffenträger at all costs. We're going to put 1 HE into his tank there. He might try pulling into me now. Going to wait to see if he does that. If he does make that mistake, I'll easily be able to pick up the kill here. And our 704 should be distracting some of the other tanks. Do you think he's still there? No! Okay. Oh, nice. Nice spotting mechanics, Wargaming. His tank was there. I don't know what those spotting mechanics are. Okay, it's whatever. And our 704 gave up. This is Mines. Mines is a trash map. What can I say? I hate Mines. It's so bad for these paper tanks. And also, we bounced 6 shots off the side of a 252U. Excellent. And it wasn't like the shots were awfully aimed either. It's like perfectly flat side shots. I'm shooting under his spaced armor, and somehow either the shots hit flat on the spaced and still bounce, or they hit under and bounce. I'm fine just sitting in KFC now and watching you stream. You're a real champ watching me stream from KFC. Forever, noob. Appreciate it. Are all of the... I hope you have like headphones on, because it probably sounds really weird hearing me talk for other Russians at KFC, I suppose. Nice RNG, bro. I know. I'm not going to blame it fully on RNG. I could have played that game better. Maybe not taking so many shots off the start and stuff like that. But, I mean, in the end, it's whatever. Gotta love it. Russian bias at its finest. Alrighty. Let's try this again. Now, we are on Faust. Not a bad lineup, I guess. They have a TVP, a Leopard, and a Skoda T50. It's just me, a P44, and a T49. Leopard is coming this way, and we have the clipping potential. Okay, so I hope whoever could have gone corner didn't go corner just yet, and there's the Skoda T50 there. Now, he hasn't spotted me up yet. Interesting. Okay, there he is. Hold up. Our Pantera is YOLOing, but he has brought down the HP. Oh, you know what? This is actually not a big brain idea. This is a very small brain idea. Yeah, no, I can't push there. There's an IC back there. There has to be an IC back there. And I just realized all of our heavy tanks are super far back. You think there's an IC in that bush? I bet there is. All right, there's the leopard. Oh, there we go. Skoda is pushing up very aggressively. We're going to put one shot into him. We're going to put a second shell into him. And heck, we might even be able to put a nice... Oh, no, we hit his manlet there. It's okay. That's not a huge issue. AMX 5100 is pulling out. So I think what I'm going to do... Oh my gosh, our shark is pulling in. Okay, you know, that works. ICU's out of the fight. The Skoda T50 is the lowest HP target here. He's the one I'm going to have to kill here. Okay, we're going to reload our clip here. We're going to put one shot into the Skoda T50. Should easily be able to pick up this kill in just a moment. Going to put a nice shell into him there. And we're going to go for the Leopard next because the Leopard is the also pretty low on hit points. So we're going to load up an AP shell, pick up a nice kill on him. Going to reload my clip here and just focus on this IS-3. Now, you know what? The IS-3 is easy to kill. Nah, the AMX is running away. Okay, since the AMX is running away, we're going to do a quick beep, 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 and get to the side of this IS-3. You're gonna pop one shell into the back of his turret. The reason I'm shooting the turret is that's where his Amarak usually is located, so if I manage to hit it, it could be beneficial. Rip. Alrighty, well, we're just gonna circle the IS-3. That sounds fun, doesn't it? Oh, no! It is 1 versus 5. What on earth happened? That's not very nice. Alright. Well, we're going to clip out the IS-3 first, so that's one shot into the IS-3. He's going to put a second shell into him. We're taking his tracks off, and then we'll pick up his kill while we keep backing up here. That's a Chimera. That's an ISU. This is not very big brain. ISU got stuck. I might get HE by the Chimera here. To be honest, though, the Chimera's HE isn't the best, so we might be able to avoid his shell temporarily now. So we're going to keep running away from the Chimera, not quite able to avoid his HE, and we are going to put some shells into this Chimera. Now, I want to make sure we can kill the Chimera here, right? And the Chimera, well, it does have good alpha damage. Oh, no, that's an AMX. Okay, we're dead. We are dead. We're going to put another shot towards the Chimera here. And we're going to try and angle up our side. I'm trying to bait an HE into our side, but the AMX probably has us. Should have kept clutching, right? But, oh god, there was just too many tanks. Could not win that once again. I don't know what happened to the entirety of the team. They just vanished. This is an F in the chat. We will win in the Skoda. Fear not. Also, ta-da! For those of you who are wondering, she is still here. This is her chair. This is where she sleeps. Otherwise, I would not have an ugly chair right here, but it's like her little bed, I guess. So yeah, good girl, Bobby. Alrighty, let's win this game. Let's win this game. I'm tired of losing. Alrighty. Let's see. Okay, Pantera's gonna spot at the mid as well as I. Oh man, I really do not like what Wargaming did to the audio. When they updated the game, they did something to the audio engine, and it sounds really weird. Everything just sounds, I don't know, it all just sounds very off-tune. Should be able to put a shot into the KP before he can shoot me back. And we're gonna pull back just a little bit. I don't wanna poke into him just yet. He's gonna be pre-aiming around the corner, right? Should be unspotted. I'm not gonna risk it. Yeah, Pantera can spot him up. Alright, there's a T49 there. We're gonna pop a shot into a T. Wow! Oh wow, T49 actually spotted me. That's epic. Okay, bushes and blitz are not like bushes and PC. It's okay. We still got a clip off. And now we know where the majority of the enemy team are. So they have three tanks above here. They have a tank over there. And then they have probably two or three tanks over on this side. Well, that's a Skoda. Interesting. We're going to put one shot into the Skoda T50 here. And he's going to back up and give us a second shot. That's good for me. And heck, we might even be able to put a third shot in. And that's a good trade. Even though I lost HP there, a 3-for-1 trade is 100% worth it. So now that Skoda is a two-shot for me. That's exactly what I was hoping for. And the Progetto should be preoccupied in a moment. I want to win this side because this is their weak side. The enemy team are weaker on this end of the map because the Progetto is pretty low on hit points. And, oh, Progetto. I think the Skoda is going to be the tank we go for. I don't want to push underneath because they're bound to have tanks above that will just poke down on me. But I do want to figure out how to pick up a kill on the Skoda. Now, okay, there's the Progetto. I'm very indecisive. I just don't want to YOLO into the enemy team just yet. That's all. There's the T49. We're going to put a shot. Oh, no. I thought he shot. I am big brain. I just got big brained by the T49. He has now pushed two shots into me. Excellent. Okay. Well, we're going to reload our clip here. We're safe. We have all of these tanks up here. Hopefully, our T49 can stay alive a little longer. I think I'm not going to take the fight anymore over here because I'm going to be spotted. But what I can do is try... Okay, because you can see their team is in the middle here. I'm going to have crossfire from above the B cap. hopefully. And I should be able to get some good farming from here and hopefully keep one of my teammates alive just a little bit longer. So we're going to wait for that T49 to pull forward. We're going to load up an HE, only hitting him for 200, but he does get taken out there. We're going to put a shot into the M103 as well. And I am using the bush to its maximum potential here. And that's so I don't get spotted, because if I get spotted, well, it's very easy for them to just turn and shoot me. But since I was using the bush, we didn't get spotted there. And we were able to get about 500 damage, and that's not too bad. Alrighty, KPFZ70 is being aggressive down here. Bulldog's clearly pushing up through the right. The Pantera is going to distract him from there. And here's my opportunity to start pushing in on this side here. I'm really hoping that the Pantera is going to distract most of their team on that side. We're going to see. I don't know what this where this KPFZ could be looking. Okay, he's not even looking at me. Excellent. Alright, so we're going to pop one shot into the KPZ here. And we're going to pop a second shot into the KPZ here. Bulldog does shoot me once, doesn't matter. Oh! Scoped out aiming for the win. That was a really bad shot. Oopsie. The good news is we should win this game. And that's all that matters in the end. So, Bulldog is all that's left. And we're just going to push up here and try and push some shots into him. So, oh god. I'm actually botting out over here. There we go. We should have the kill. Ah, not quite. Don't mind my shooting. We were trying to look cool with the scoped out shots, and it didn't quite work out as planned. Hi, kitty. Alright, 3.7k. Okay, I'm done. I'm done with the Skoda T50 for now. Let's go back to the TVP. Let's get some more exciting gameplay in here. What are you doing, Maisie? I don't think the shark is OP. You know what I think is OP is the side armor 252U bouncing 6 shells from a tier 9 medium tank. That's OP. My microphone is blocking it, but the cat is just sitting here staring at the wall. It's very fascinating. Alrighty, so back in the TVP. Let's get some exciting gameplay going here. And just looking around. Enemy team, they have double TVPs. They have a standard B, a Kronwagen. It is Normandy, so this is going to be a holdout map. So, question is, what do I want to do here? Honestly, I love spotting up the mid, but given just the fact that they have a Kronwagen, I'm not sure if I want to do that. I will go up to this bush and see if I can get any early spots. Okay, there's the tier 9 bat chat. I wonder if we can get an HE clip into him at all. We're going to put one HE shell into him there for 200. We're going to put a second HE into him. We're going to put a third HE into... Oh, no! So our HE is not being very pog. At least the last one max rolled. Our whole clip there was 1100. It was legitimately less than if I just shot AP. If I'd penned all my HE, we would have one clip to the bat chat. But unfortunately, that is not the situation. Alright, excellent work to our TVP picking up the kill in the bat chat there. I think, we can start working up the mid. Now, there's a Kronwagen coming back for our TVP. I'm going to see if I can help our TVP while he runs away from the Kronwagen. Kronwagen should be distracted by him momentarily, so we're going to put one shot into the Kron. Going to track the Kron in the open. We're going to put two shots into the Kron. We're going to put a third shot into the Kron, pulling back from him before he can put more than one shot into me, and a third shot into him. Excellent. And now there's a TVP pushing in behind us, so here's where we kind of pull back just a little bit. I'm going to angle up my rear here. I just tried to avoid all the shots right now. I don't know where the Waffenträger is. That's kind of an issue. Okay, the VK-72 is coming back as well. Standard B is overcommitted with the TVP up top. I think we pull back. I don't think committing here is a great idea. Oh, no. No, get off my side. Dude, just go. Just turn. Oh my gosh. And we're going to get clipped out by this Kronwagen. Well, if our AMX pens one shell, we should be able to win this 1v1. Okay, well, that worked. And that's where having a massive clip is very helpful. Mind you, my driving wasn't perfect, but if the AMX had turned a little bit sideways, that would have been nice. Alright, we're going to go clip out, I think, the VK-72 now. I think the Waffenträger is about to get TVP'd, or he has already been TVP'd. We might be able to three-shot him, though. Oh, he's AFK. Shh, don't tell anyone. He's definitely not AFK. Okay, I'm going to save my shots, actually. We're going to go for the VK. If he's AFK, he's not shooting at anyone. He's causing no harm. So it's going to put one shot into the VK, and we should be able to put a second shot. Oh no, we missed. RIP to our standard B going down there, and that is game over. We're just going to YOLO the VK. Actually, I take that back. The VK is going to out-reload me. Not very pog. We're going to get behind this building. Just going to wait for him to shoot at the AMX. Perfect. There we go. That's what we wanted. And he's perma-tracked in the open, so we're going to put one shot into his side. We're going to put two shots into his eye, and we should be able to pick up... Not quite. Okay, 5k. Back on the 5k run. Much, much better. All right, well, I have been doing an awful job of reading chat this stream. Probably why I'm generally speaking playing better, but I don't feel like I'm being as good of a streamer if I'm not communicating with you guys. Fatness with Mercedes driving around on Godzilla. Wait, what? I have no idea what you're trying to say, dude. Sweaty farmer moment. Yes. Best mods equal WoT Joe. Get WoT Joe in here. I'll make him a mod. Remove 252 you. I low-key want to agree with you on that one, because... Wait, what? Okay. I'll take that. I didn't even know. Maybe we can get the 4K. Alrighty. HRF bot confirmed. Affirm, HRF is confirmed a bot. T125, it seems pretty fun. It is pretty fun. I played it at the start of the stream. I played all of the tanks at the start of the stream, actually, because I wanted to show everyone what the tanks were like, if they're interested. But obviously, most people are here for the crown jewel, you could say. The TVP and the Škoda T50 are both very solid vehicles that I think most people would come here for that. All right, it's Canyon. The enemy team have an STB and a Leopard 1. They also have two solid tier 9 heavy tanks, a lot of TDs. They're gonna hold mid, and they're gonna do a good job holding mid. I'm going to do an unusual spotting run where I go down here, because I won't be able to outdo the STB up top, very likely. My goal is to figure out where is their team coming from. Now, I don't think the STB will spot me from there. No, he can't. He doesn't have the turret. Okay. And we're just gonna see if anyone crosses up late. Now, so far, no one's been spotted, except, you know, there's a Leopard coming this way. There's a 183 in the back. There's also a Jaeger back there. And I do have a Super Conk and a Progetto with me. Intuition tells me most of their team did go right. And that's why I took the aggressive spotting run, as I wanted to figure out right off the bat, hey, where's their team coming from? So we're gonna put a nice double splash into the STB and the Leopard. We did 200 damage combined between them. Another shot into the STB and a track shot into the STB again. We're making him pull all the way down, and now he's gonna pull into a Super Conk and a Progetto. I don't know what this STB is doing, to be honest. Yep, okay, good job. Excellent. Guys, please don't do it, that STB one. Just please don't. There's no point. He could have pulled over with the Leopard. The Leopard's still alive. There's no need to just do YOLOs like that. It makes no sense why you would do a YOLO like that. Alrighty. Well, back to the gameplay now. Enemy team to have C. They also have a tank destroyer that can one-shot me, which is not very fun. And trying to consider my options here. There's a K91 behind us. Now, K91 is clipping out our teammate right here, so we should be able to put one shot into him. Gonna put a second shot into him and a third shot for about 2,000 damage this game. Not too bad. Not too bad of a start of a game. All right, ST1 pushing up down mid. We know where the YAG is. We know where the 183 is. I think we know where the 4,005 is. And how can we best farm damage here? Well, you can see that is a yellowing Leopard, and he wants to die. And I will happily oblige and provide him as quick and painless death as possible. So we're going to YOLO in onto this Leopard 1 over here and try and get a clip into him before he can pull all the way around the corner. Putting a good track shot into him there, and unable to pick up the kill. But we did take off his tracks twice. There's also an ST1. Yikes, I don't know where that shot went. There we go. All right, not too bad, not too bad. I'm just looking at how the game's going. So the YAG's in the river, the 183's up top, 4,005 is low. There's no way we would really lose this, not with our team composition. So I can just YOLO, and hopefully with one more clip, we'll get about 3,500, 3,700 damage or so. That's the goal. That's the goal of the game. Now, I'm not sure where that 183 is exactly. Now, we might be able to get a nice shot in on towards the Jaegeru here if he pulls forward. Oh, he's getting tracked, though. Don't get tracked. That's not cool. Getting tracked is never cool. Okay, 4,005 goes down. 183 has to be in the river, right? So are we going to big brain on him? Where's that 183 at? Oh, the 183 went up top. Okay. That's fine. Where's the YAG looking? Okay, YAG's not quite looking. Should be able to pop a nice shot into him. That's good. And he's still not quite looking, so we'll pull up a second shell into him. We might even be able to clip him out here, heck. Excellent. Excellent. We're gonna pop a second shot into a third shell, and that's a quick and easy kill for about 4,000 or so damage. Another decent game in the TVP. A little bit below average, actually. Fannis likes to drink vodka and playing Russian tank. He goes glug glug and Stalin guides him. I don't know. Did you see my last stream? I don't think I had very much guidance. Yeah, I haven't seen TJ either, and I told him to get on, and once again, he has neglected to get on and help me. I was gonna make him a mod. I don't know why he doesn't want to be. He's a wargaming mod. He should be a stream mod as well. He'd be perfect for it. Oh my gosh, 348 likes. We're almost at 350 likes. Can we get to 350? All right, TVP is the only med they have, as well as me. They have a mouse and E100, double 1A3s, and a lot of heavy tanks. Okay, I'm going to go A, just because they have so many heavy tanks here. My goal is to try and kill the TVP and their TDs while avoiding those heavy tanks for the start of this game. Either that or farm the heavy tanks. Either option's good. What I'm going to do for here is try and see if I can spot up that TVP. Is that TVP crossing to the left? Is he crossing to the right? We will find out. So far, it appears he went towards the encounter area. Oh no, he's behind encounter cap. Okay, cool. So, do we big brain and we blind fire for TDs? We're going to take one blind shot. We're going to take two blind shots. I'm being very anxious about these blind shots because I don't want to get hit back by a 183 or something over there. Alrighty. So, TVP's still there. Oh, I should have saved my clip. I could have clipped him out now. Okay, you know what? I think I can create an angle to clip this TVP soon. No! I'm clipping and he's running away in the open. Wait, we still might be able to get some good shots into him though. It's too risky to shoot HE from this distance, so we'll put an AP shot into him. At least one AP shell. There we go. Excellent work. Okay. 600 damage! We blind fired someone. I told you we would blind fire one player. Well, I didn't tell you that, but I thought we would, and we did. We blind fired, I think, one of the 183s. Excellent. Okay. So, E75 is pushing into the mid. We're going to let him do that, because once he overexposes, gets distracted, and then we bop an entire clip into him. So, we're going to wait. Wait for this. Wait for the E75. He's going to poke around the corner. And ta-da, E75 is poked, and ta-da, he's going to lose about 1300 HP, just like this. So, we're going to put another shot into him, and we're going to load up heat for that. Oh, God. Could not get that shot in. It's okay. E75 still lost half his hit points there. Not too bad. And just looking at how things are going, I think we can just hold on the right-hand side. So, the mouse is in the mid. E100 is going to be looking at me, but they're going to want to shoot the waffle, right? Who wouldn't want to shoot a juicy Waffenträger in the open? Do you think they're going to be pre-aiming for me? There's a chance they're pre-aiming for me here. They might be. We'll see. Okay, there's the 100. E75 certainly is. What about the 100? And so is the 100. Not quite able to hit them there. It's okay. I'm holding their heavy tanks out of the fight, I guess. I mean, if I have... Oh my gosh, that's a TVP. We're going to want to run away from that. There we go. Just get away from the TVP there. And we're going to act like we're running away. Now, in reality, we're big-braining. And we're pulling all the way into our spawn. And we're going sneak mode, and we're going to try and kill that TVP as quickly as possible. Question is, will we have shots on the E75 first? And something tells me we certainly will. So we're going to try and put one shot into the E75. Not quite able to hit that one. That one misses the 100 somehow. Going to put a second shot into the 100. And we should be able to put a third shell in and then just run away. Aye, aye, aye. That was not very clean. Gun is trolling me. When does the stream end? Whenever my battery dies. That's usually when the stream ends. So about 2.5 to 3 hours, depending on how good my battery is working today. Okay, I don't think we're spotted. And now we can finally kill this E75, who should have died a long time ago. Finally. All right. Not the cleanest playing by me, but we were able to make it work in the end. Yay. There we go. And I'm going to work down the C100 now. The TVP on the enemy team could still be floating around. I don't think he has a ton of HP left, though. Okay, that's not good. Where's that TVP at? I don't want to commit anywhere until I know where that TVP is, because I'm a three shot for the TVP, right? Is he over here? Oh no, that's not... There's no way I was still spotted there. There's actually no way I was still spotted there. What? Ah, the timing there was unfortunate. Feels bad. Rip the average damage. Oh well. Cry about it every time. Nothing I can do about it. Aww. You know, whenever I get sad, I just look over here and I'm like, good kitty. Yeah, I got kind of wrecked there. Kind of a rip. I don't know, RNG, like some of those shots that were just bouncing, like, my shooting was a little off, and of course, the 183 was just yoding through C-cap. I need to read chat. I'm not keeping up with chat. I'm such a bad streamer. Fan is arm tattoos, indeed. Yo, fan is play to Skoda T25, play Skoda. Play Skoda T25. Okay, do you guys really want to see Skoda T25? I'll play a game in it again. I don't mind. It's good to drop a tier every once in a while. All right. Enemy team have a bad chat. Standard B, a T54 EAP1. It is me, a leopard, and double leopards, actually. We should be able to win this fight. I'm going to spot up down the mid really aggressively here. Anyone that crosses to the corner will get wrecked. And by anyone, I mean no one, because no one's crossed to the corner yet. So enemy team are clearly going towards C, which means our Fosh is going to get absolutely ripped apart. But what I can do is we're going to pull up mid here, and I think we'll get an early clip off on one of their TDs. That's going to be the plan for this game. And speaking of TDs, there's the 183. So that's one shot into the 183. We're going to pop two shots into the 183. And heck, we might even be able to put a shell on towards the 50B. Oh god, I thought the 50B was behind the hill. Shouldn't have taken that shot. It's okay. Not bad, not bad. Only soft music, please. Strategist music is OP. Okay, good. I'm glad you guys enjoy the music, for the most part. Okay, not everyone's going to be happy, because obviously difference in tastes. But overall, as long as it's not too bad. All of the music, by the way, is by Harris Heller. He runs a record called Stream Beats, and all of his songs are copyright free, which is great. And he's constantly adding new music to it, so it's pretty awesome. I like his. He runs a YouTube channel about streaming and stuff, so I found it pretty helpful. That's why I use his music. And yeah, okay, there we go. T-54-E1. Ay. Okay, what are we gonna do here? They have a 183 in their spawn. They have a Yag up in the mid. We're losing the C fight, but that's not a huge surprise. I mean, we have a VK90. Actually, no, VK90 is going Chad mode over there. VK90 legitimately is undefeatable sometimes. Off the rear of a bat chat. Excellent. At least we got the second shot in. Okay, bat chat, you're going to pull forward, aren't you? Just waiting for this bat chat. I think what we should do here is just clip out, to be honest. Yeah. Yeah, we're just going to clip out. Okay, I was saving a shot so I could make the batch out a one-shot, but I think the VK's got him with the KPFZ. We're going to cap B. The AG's going to pull around the corner soon. Shouldn't be too bad. Alrighty. And hopefully the Yagaru or 50B will both be right around the corner. There's the 50B. We're going to put one shot into the 50B there. We're going to put two shots into the 50B. We might take a shell from him here, but we should be able to put a third shot into him as well. Excellent. That is a nice full clip into that 50B. Making good use of the gun. And if we get one more clip in towards this Yag Panzer E100, that should put me at about, oh, I don't know, 3,600 damage or so if we get one more clip off. So that's my goal. Get one more clip off. I don't think we have shots in the 50B. Aha, we do, actually. RIP 50B. Oh, no, what a waste. Okay. And it is just this Yagaru left. Not a bad game. I played a little bit passively this game. I don't know. Some of these games are just, it's really weird. You don't know exactly where to push in. Especially when the enemy team were just holding everywhere. But our team did good job. Good job to the VK90. He did great work there. My stream just had a heart attack. Did it have a heart attack? Is the stream quality still good? No lag? I didn't see any. Not bad. Okay, we still did 3K. I'll take it. It's a solid game. RIP this game. Yeah, we got brained on there. Alrighty. Epic. Fatness tier 6 gameplay. Doesn't get much better than that, does it? Hello, kitty. Don't mind the cat. Alrighty. Yeah, thank you everyone, by the way, for liking the stream. We're at 391, which means we are almost at 400 likes. Can we break 400 likes? I think we can do it. I think we can definitely do it. Thank you, Economics Mate. I appreciate it. We'll see. It depends on how often I can really stream and make videos. It does take time for me to do this, and as like a full-time student, I don't have a ton of time to do streaming and stuff, like, as often as I'd love to, but you know, well, I'm gonna still try once a week, when possible. We'll see. Finals week might be a bit of an exception when that comes around. Alrighty. Wait, we're not in a TVP. We're not in a Škoda T50. We're in a Škoda T25. We are in the superior Škoda. Okay, so for some people, it's been lagging a little bit, but it looks pretty good on my end, so I'm going to assume it's not too bad. Alrighty, we're going to put one shot into this dude, we're going to put two shots into this dude, and not too bad start of the game. And hopefully this Hellcat's actually a really good tank, won't want to overpoke that at all. Okay, Škoda, Hellcat, Škoda, one of you are going to poke up soon. I'm not going to clip out till one of you poke up. Aha, gun handling. All right, so it's just me and an M4, the enemy team, or Škoda T, another Škoda 225 and a Leopard. Enemy team have a few tanks over here, but I think that their heavy tanks are probably in D, right? So this shouldn't be too bad. All right, So we're going to casually just brain on this VK 2801 now. Gonna put one shot, two shot, and wow, this tank is good. I didn't play too many games at the start. This is a solid vehicle. If you're grinding down the line, I would say skipping this is pointless. I think this tank is probably the tier 6 that's most like the TVP. So it's definitely a good tank to get you used to the playstyle of the TVP line. So I would say don't skip this tank. It's solid. Heck, I might even buy it on my account, even though I already have the Skoda T50 on my account. I might just get this just for memes. It's a fun little tank, isn't it? Alrighty, and here's this spike over here. We're gonna put one more shot into the spike, and we should be able to pick up a nice kill on him as well. Loading up maybe high explosive for a shell into the side. Not quite. 200 max roll there. There we go. Not too bad. I like, we're doing okay. We have about 1800 damage so far. Not too shabby indeed. We have 408 likes now. Thank you everyone so much for helping us break that 800 like mark. Excellent. We are making good progress as a stream. We're going to put another shot into the Skoda. We're going to pick up a kill into the Skoda. And heck, we might even be able to pick up a kill into the Hellcat as well. Excellent. And now it's just a Kuromori mine, which is not able to do much. So, yeah, I don't know. I'm just making sound effects because I don't know what to say. It's tier 6. This is so unnatural. Okay, one more shot, and a kill shot. Excellent. This clip is really good. Wow, I like it. Wait, what's left? It's this M4 Sherman. What's the bet that the M4 could be AFK? Has he been spotted all game? I could pick up 6 kills this battle. It's good. I like this tank. Anyone who hasn't played the Skoda T25, it's a solid tier 6. The clip on it is surprisingly good. Oh, there's the M4. And that's 3,000 damage for the game. Game over. Not too bad. All right. We're doing good here, boys. We're doing good. So there you go. For everyone who requested the Skoda T25, that is the Skoda T25. It's very similar to a lot of the TVP tanks. And I'm pretty sure I've played this tank twice and I have like 100% ace in it, ace ratio in it. Not too bad. No way. I didn't ace it the first try. Did I? I don't remember. I'll have to look back. All righty. So there you go. I hope you guys enjoyed. Now, I refuse to play the You know what? When I played the TVP VTU, I was lagging. I'm going to give it the benefit of the doubt and try it one more time and see if it's better than when I was lagging when I played it earlier. So we'll give it a go. Maybe it will be good. Maybe it won't. We'll see. I felt like the gun had a ton of potential on this tank. So it is Canal. That's not a bad map for us, actually. And I think what I'm going to do here is we're just going to pull up towards the right-hand side and try and make things work to our best ability. We have a pretty solid medium force. 4 med lights versus 3. Should be able to win this side of the map. Tanks, I appreciate the donation. Thank you very much. And, epic salt shaker. Appreciate it. Alrighty. What's the bet the enemy team didn't actually send mini tanks over here? Interesting. Oh, do you think he spotted me? I don't know. He definitely spotted me now. Alright. So our team managed to cap D pretty early. Not bad. They could have a Waffenträger holding the back. They probably sent T-49s into A. That's the most logical decision. And I'm going to be very aggressive here. But I think what I can do is if I stay unspotted. Ooh, that's a T-49 over there. Okay, we're going to push onto this T-49. And we're going to go for a ram. Ram. Oh, yes, thank you. I appreciate your contribution to my damage, Mr. T-49. This P-49 is massive. Alrighty. Oh, thank you. Cat emoji. Even better. Thank you, tanks. You're always a real one in these streams. Alrighty. T26 up in the mid. We got an LTTB up in the mid. T28 is probably going to be looking towards the Bulldog now, which means theoretically I should be able to get some shots onto him. This is high risk though, because they have a Borsig that can shoot me from the corner, right? So if I overextend up here, I'm going to get aped by the Borsig. So the more logical decision here, I can still poke up top. And yeah, there's that Borsig I was talking about, right? I can just go down the river all the way, and then I can still farm out the mid here, but I'll be safe from the Borsig. So that's kind of the whole goal. We're going to get safe from the Borsig and farm him out. So yeah, I mean, the tank isn't that bad. It's not amazing. Like I thought, it's not amazing, but it's not awful. I mean, it's bearable. I think it's better than probably some tier 8 medium tanks. Is it the most pog of medium tanks? Probably not, but it is bear. Oh my god. He just got wrecked. Well, that was a little bit unfortunate. I was hoping to farm damage on the Borsig, but it's okay. T49 doing a Chad job. Our team is still kind of losing this, so it's a good job he nuked him, actually. All right, wait, I hear another dono. No, bad shot. Gotta watch out for all these tanks. And now it is the poop emoji. Excellent. Let's see. Ah, finally, we're hitting shots now. I don't feel like such a nub anymore. What do you think that Borsig is? I'm a one shot to the Borsig. I need this. Oh no, did our T49 die? Oh, when did that happen? Big unfortunate. There we go. Essential kill there. I'm gonna run away from the Tiger now. And try and farm up this 112 as best I can. So this is a very close game. We're able to put a shot towards the 112 there. Excellent. They still have a T28 on very healthy hit points. And our Pantera needs to drop down if possible. He can't sit there any longer. Come on, Pantera, get out of there. No, Pantera. We're gonna put another shot towards this dude. Okay, not bad. The issue is I'm a one shot here, so yeah, I don't know what I'm supposed to really do, to be honest. This isn't that winnable. Oh, did we actually get spotted? Wow, we got spotted before we even shot. Excellent. And there's a Tiger P, that Tiger 1. He's gonna keep progressing forward. I'm just gonna keep holding here for now, I guess. And we'll put another shot into the Tiger there. Oh, good shot by the Tiger, I guess. And we're gonna die. We're gonna die. Oh, this tank is humongous. No. I don't see us living very long this game, my guys. F in the chat for the... Oh, God. That was a bad shot. No. All right. Bounce. Oh, we got the bounce. Excellent news. Oh, maybe we can bait him. Oh, no. We low rolled. it was worth a try. It was worth a try. Thank you for all of these beautiful emojis, tanks. I appreciate it. I know. It was a rip. Couldn't do much there. I mean, we did 3.5. Some of the shots I had there were kind of sketchy. Some of the shots he took there were sketchy. Overall, not a huge fan of the tank, but it's not like awful or anything. It's just one of those tanks you have to grind to do well in it. Alrighty. Didn't miss anything interesting in the chat. At least I don't think so. I'm only checking chat for like 5 seconds between games. I need to spend more time reading chat. All right, back into the TVP. We are once again on Fort Despair. Uh-huh. Don't like this map for the TVP, but we will make it work. Okay, what's our team doing? Obviously, our team's going towards the C side of the map. So I'm not going to go A. There's really no point in that. Not with my whole team going towards the right-hand side. So what I'm going to do instead is just work my way down the middle here and try and see if I can get any early farm. Heck, they don't have any heavy tanks. No, just double clippers and an IS-8. I'm going to be super aggressive here then. Because I think they're going to send most, if not all, of their vehicles really aggro towards the middle of the map. And then they might have a few tanks back here. But other than that, they won't have a ton. All right, yeah, we do get spotted up by the Gorilla 15 there, who's going to probably back up to try and shoot at me. That's fine. I'm going to put a shot in towards the Gorilla there. Do manage to bait a shot from the Gorilla there. I'm not going to push across. Pushing across is a bad idea. Why? They're going to have a ton of tanks in the encounter cap. Just watch what happens to these guys. Okay. Wait, did they actually make it across? Oh, okay, the 50B took one shot. Yeah, that wasn't too bad. Okay, I way over anticipated where the enemy team was going to be. Oh no, I thought they were going to get nuked and they didn't. I mean, that's good that they didn't get nuked. Interesting, so we now have the enemy spawn. Kind of. Do we have shots on the 57? Not quite. The rock's providing good cover fire for him. I'm going to push on to the 62A there. Gonna load up a nice little heat shell. Putting heat shell in there. I'm actually spotted. Okay. So, there's a 121 in the back, and he's giving our 183 a very not cool time. But I don't know what I can do about it. I have a Moishin here. The Moishin's gonna come back and help. We're gonna go kill the 121. He's isolated. Guarantee he has very little to no support where he is. And as long as the Moishin stays in the vicinity, we should be able to pick up a pretty easy kill on him, right? So we're going to try and put one shot into the 121, pinning him through his turret there, which is great for me. And I needed to put like two more shots into him to make him one clippable. Because that was the goal, make him one clippable if possible. Alrighty. 62A is now YOLOing in. We're going to put one shot into the 62A there. Ta-da. And now we're just going to act like we're running away and then wait for the 62A to push in behind us. We're going to put one shot. Oh no! We actually bounced off his rear. Put another shot into him. Alrighty, well, that wasn't too bad. We have a Leopard over here. So what I did this game, I definitely rode back through our spawn because I didn't want to push into their spawn without a bunch of TDs and a bunch of heavies just holding there, right? The 1-2-1 was pretty isolated over here. He's pretty, you know, overextended. My team is hopefully going to be able to pressure him. And as long as I have support from this leopard, which appears we do not, we're going to put a nice ram into the 1-2-1. We're going to put a second shell into him. We're going to put a third shell into him. Oh, wait, we ricocheted? No. Oh, Moishin. Moishin, and your assistance is required. it's whatever. We'll pick up a kill on the 1-2-1 in just a moment. I think the 57's distracted. The leopard's not here. So, yeah. I'll pick up a kill on the 1-2-1. Do-do-do-do. All right. And we are pressuring forward. Alright, so 57's gonna be over in the open. Maybe I shouldn't have reloaded my clip just yet. Okay, he's not looking. Now, where's that grill? The grill's still in their spawn. We have a lot of one-shots. Actually, we have three potential one-shots this game. We're gonna have to be really careful about not overextending here. Nice by the leopard. Gets an essential kill. And, of course, the other team goes down as well. Great work to our team. Now this 57 heavy has fired twice, maybe three. He's fired three times. He just reloaded his clip. Trying to put one shell into him. We're going to try and take his tracks off again. And that should leave us free to put some high explosive shells into the rear of his tank. Oops, that's how you run into a leopard's carcass. Okay, there we go. I just wanted to try and bring his HP down as much as possible. The Moishin should be able to pick up a kill if he rushes me. GG, about 5,000 or so damage. Not too bad. Is the stream lagging? It doesn't look like it's lagging from my end, and I usually can tell if it's lagging. Yeah, it's not right now. Maybe it was lagging earlier. And we get a kill on the 57. Great! 5k. Gosh, I am loving this tank. Alright, guys. Okay, good. No lag. Excellent, excellent. Yeah, we're doing pretty good. We're doing pretty good. Another ace in the TVP T50. You could definitely see that this tank thrives end game, right? If you just keep your HP in this tank and you have like above 1,000 hit points when there's only a few tanks left, this tank will just absolutely rip the enemy team apart. It's really good. Alrighty. Leopard, Sheridan, me. We should have hill. I'm gonna go for an early hill run spot and take a drink of water. His royal royalty, indeed. Fannis, can I get a shout out? You just did. All right, there's the 50B crossing up the hill. That's what I wanted to spot up. There's also an E5 there, and this is where we put at least one, if not two, shells in towards this E5. We're going to put a second shot into him for 600 there. Yak Tiger not quite giving me the shells I needed, but we were able to spot up their tanks pretty early, and not too bad. Not too bad of a start. So that's exactly why I was so aggressive up top there, is I wanted to spot what was going up the hill, and then I would use that information to, you know, get some early shots off maybe. And now we know what they have up here, right? Their whole team. We know their whole team's up here. I think that's pretty obvious. And I'm just going to kind of hold this angle. Now the E50M is kind of tunneling down this angle, down this alley. There's no point in me poking. I'm not going to get, like, if you're going to trade shots one for one, you're not using the TVP correctly. So I'm not going to even try and trade with that E50M. However, our Sheridan might be able to distract the enemy team a little bit here. I'm trying to see. They have a Yag Tiger that could go outside. The only reason I don't want to push on the outside of this hill is they very likely do have... yeah, there's the Yak Tiger. And that's why you don't want to overextend on the outside of the hills, because tanks like this Yak Tiger will just rip you apart. Now, he did manage to put a shot into him at least, but you can see why pushing on the outside of the hill, unless you have a bunch of tanks in town, as we do here, it's very risky, because these tanks here will just farm you out. Gonna put a shot into the CRB, gonna load high explosive, hitting him for... Oh no, that didn't pen. That was a splash. Sag. Alright, CRB is gonna get taken out. E50M being pretty aggressive. Now we have a Yag here, a Leopard, and a Sheridan. This is a great crossfire. I can now start progressing on this E50M and Yag Tiger because the enemy team has so many tanks on the hill and we have so many tanks just chilling in the entrance of town. This leaves me free to start farming up the enemy team. And we're going to HE this 50B's turret, absolutely ripping them apart with high explosive ammo there. And we're even going to be able to put a nice, hopefully a nice shot into the E50M. Not quite, but I can pull back here into safety and the Yag is going to pull it forward so this E50M can't even push on me. Excellent. TVP is a tank of high risk, though, that I need to watch out for. Looks like our Sheridan gets absolutely pepegoed over there. And there's an IS-4 on very healthy over here. There's also an E50M over here. Now, the E50M is being super aggressive, so we're going to take advantage of that. Thank you so much for the... wait. Are you, wait, did you just donate asking for a shout out? I can't see. Okay, let me see. Super chat. I just did my shout out. Good job. Thank you so much for the donation. Oh no, this is not good. And here's where we die. Unless he low rolls me. That's okay. We did our job that game. Our team's gonna win. TVP came in kind of... actually, no. Our team's not gonna win. We don't have the HP. I just realized. Not bad. There you go. You got your shout out. I mean, that was a rip. I don't know what I could have done there. We still did like 3,000... 3,500 or so damage. Not too bad. Not too bad. Where did your super chat go? 16-bit replays. Oh, it's right here. Your super chat's here, and it also showed up on the stream. It's pretty awesome, right? All right, let's go back into this Skoda T50. What's my battery? 19%? Wow, how does the time go by so fast? Question, can we get to 450 likes before the stream is over? Let's do it, guys. I think we can do it. We're only 24 likes away from 450. So if you haven't liked the stream, please feel free to smash that like button and subscribe for more content. I just went into outro mode right there. Alrighty, we're gonna push up to A now. In this Skoda T50, tier 9 matchup, enemy team have a T55A, and that's about it. T55A, and I think that's a Lorraine? Is that a Lorraine? No, it's a 5100. Oh, a 1390. But they have sent tanks onto C, and no one spotted on the rails. So this tells me they have a lot of tanks in town. They might send tanks through B. Interesting. What's the bet they're gonna have a tank over on their rails? Yeah, the T55A is gonna be looking at me. I'm not gonna poke over top. That's a bad idea. Do I have support? I do have support from the T92 and the other vehicles. All right, and oh, that's a T28. Okay, so we should be able to almost clip out this T28 here. So we're gonna put one shot, we're gonna put two shots, and we should be able to put a heat shell right there. Oh, no, we missed completely. Excellent. And we do have a T34-3 and a T92 here, so I'm not too worried about getting pushed on right now. I'm just gonna kind of hold behind the enemy team and farm out best we can. Alrighty, not bad, not bad. If this T55A or 1390 in that instance both YOLO over, their team, one of them's gonna get clipped out. And there's the T28 prototype. So we're gonna load up a heat shell here. One heat shell bouncing. We're gonna put a second heat shell into him. Hopefully we don't low roll here. Oh, and we roll exactly 1 HP. Epic RNG. T28 gets left on 1 hit point. Oh my gosh. Okay. See, we had some spam in the chat, but I don't know what it says. A lot of Fs. F in the chat. only one, so don't spam it, though. Alright, I think our team's got this. I think our team has got this. How to get TJ's attention? Spam. Yeah, that's how you get TJ to remove you from the stream. Alrighty, what do we got here? There's the IS-8. We're gonna clip out the IS-8. He is in one clip range, and oh no. And one more shot. Easy. Oh, we got the fire too. Excellent. And we should be able to pick up a kill onto this KPF Z70 next here. Who gets a nice Maxwell? Good for him. And, yeah, what's the old Waffenträger? He's looking kind of juicy. Ram! Ugh. Yes. And shoot HE at my side. Okay, he's going to get killed by a T-34. Oh, no. Ah. Not bad, not bad. I don't know if we got 3K. Oh, wow. 459 likes. You guys went above and beyond. Excellent work. Thank you. Oh, Fidu, you're here. Where's Fidu? Well, I can see your I see your interactive here. I don't see you typing. Shout out, Fidu. Thank you for showing up. Oof, we didn't do so good there. Okay, I knew we were gonna lose that game. We still did good. I mean, good job to the IS4. He did 5K. I mean, yeah. Yeah, we still did 3.7. I'll take it. Let's go back into TVP. Alright, how much battery do we have left? 17%. I think that's enough for 5 or so more battles. So if you have a particular tank that you really must see in this tech tree, kind of tech tree review showcase, put in the comments which vehicle you want to see that I'm not already running. So I'm running the TVP, obviously, whatever. So because I don't have a ton of games left in terms of battery life, so I want to make sure everyone gets to see one of the Czech tanks that they're interested in. Challenge you to ace the TVP 50. TVP VTU. Have I not aced that tank yet? No, I have not. I've aced all of them except for the TVP VTU. I should do that. All right, there's a Vickers. We're going to... Oh, nope, we're going to bounce off the side. What am I doing? You do not play the mid in this tank. That is very big brain. This tank does not have the armor, as you can see, to play mid. Oh, well, I got too distracted reading chat, and my brain went to autopilot mode, so it's time to start big braining. Well, our Vickers is running away, which is a little unfortunate. I wish our Vickers was here, because he has a better turret, and he has the view range to work the mid, whereas I don't, so I'm just going to chill here for now. Now, the question is, what do I have for cover fire? Not much. There's the Kron, though, and there's also a Ho-Ri. We're going to go for a Trax on the Ho-Ri. Not quite able to hit his Trax there. Do hit him twice, though, at least there. Not too bad, and the Ho-Ri loses a ton of hit points. Okay, not so bad. There's E50M. E50M is being really aggressive now up here, and we're actually getting YOLO'd. So hopefully, yep, E50M, you just made a huge mistake. There's an AMX, there's a 268, and a standard B here. Oh no, he's, what's that meme where it's like someone runs into something and like they immediately just like, they just freeze and they're like slowly backing up. I forget what it is, but that E50M just did that. He just went to YOLO me and then there's four tanks right behind me. Oh, that was epic. Okay, we're gonna try and clip out this E100 as he's going on the crossing. One shell into the E100, should be able to put a second shell into the E100, taking his tracks off there, should be able to put a third shell in the E100, then we're just gonna pull back. And once he gets distracted, pulling forward or backwards, we'll put our final shell into him, right? We'll just wait for him. All right. And there's actually a Vickers over here, but we're going to shoot the 100 anyways. Bad shot. Bad shot. Oh my gosh, we have a lot of people spamming right now. Oh yeah, good job. Good job to our team, man. Our team came back clutch there and they just countered that E50M's YOLO so hard. I appreciate it. And we are on the long clip. Okay. So we know where the Vickers is, roughly know where the Ho-Ri is, we know where the E100 is. The question is, can we clip out this E100 without getting ourselves killed? I need to wait till this E100 gets distracted. That's one shot into the E100, we're gonna have to pull back here. I'm scoped out here because it allows me to keep more attention on what's going on around me. If I was scoped in, I wouldn't be able to pay attention as much to what's going on. Alright, so we're going to ignore the E100 now because we have shots on the 54 and the Ho-Ri, I believe. And we're going to go for the 54. Oh no, he got bumped by his teammate. Excellent. There we go, E100 goes down. Oh gosh, I'm so used to running 3-shot autoloaders. I forgot I had a 4-shell in the clip. My brain went on instinct mode there. Do you use Elgato? Yes, I use Elgato. I use the Elgato capture card to hopefully provide you a decent streaming experience. It kind of makes up for not always the most reliable Wi-Fi, but I think this stream, we've been pretty good. I have not noticed any major lag, which makes me happy because I'm used to playing on major lag. Alrighty, E75 is going to be my target here. He's not paying attention, so we're going to put one shot into the E75. We're going to put two shells into the E75 here. And let's see, there's a Kron here. I actually need to kind of get out of any crossfire, but we should still pick up a kill on the E75 anyways. There's going to be a Vickers over here on my left somewhere. Not quite. Okay, where's that Vickers at? Okay, he's not here. All right, I'm going to go for a reload. We might get yelled by the Kron. In that case, the best option, I think, for me is just to back up. Because that way, if the Vickers is still there, I won't get clipped out, right? So we're going to chill here for a moment. I'm going to reload a full clip, and then we'll clip out whoever goes next. Hey, oh, AMX 5100, 120, pushing in like a G. Should be able to spot them up easily. And there is the Kronwagen, who does get one shell to me. Now, I outclip him. No, the Vickers is pre-aiming, though. Okay, we're going to put one shot into the Kron there. The Kron bounces a shell on us. We're going to put a Trax onto him, and we should be able to pick up almost a kill. Oh my god, we really low-rolled our clip there. Aha! AMX 5120 gets him. Good job. All right, not too bad. Not too bad. I take that trade on the Kron. I think that was good. And it's just this Vickers Light that's left who probably is going to push for me because I'm a one-shot and, you know, juicer one-shots. Ah, I shouldn't have even reloaded my clip. Not bad. Okay. What has the chat been up to while I've been preoccupied sweating in a game? I don't think the TVP is going to get nerfed at all. No. It's great, but it's not the kind of tank. What's my stats in the TVP VT? Ooh, 3k average, but 50% win rate and 0 aces. We'll try it again. Yeah, I don't know. I think the TVP is balanced. I don't see it being an issue. The only thing I can see the TVP being a little bit broken is it's high explosive. I think if the HE was 400 flat, it'd be much more balanced. Having, I think, is 420 alpha HE rounds, it makes no sense, right? You're pretty much one clipping almost any tier 9 TD or tier 9 light tank. with HE. It just doesn't make sense why it should be that good. Otherwise, I think the tank's pretty balanced. And of course, it's a little annoying in a platoon. And yes, I am running the VTU again, and that's because I was challenged to ace this vehicle. So yes, I'll play it two times. If I don't ace it in those two games, I'm going to play a different tank because battery life. And no one wants to sit here watching the VTU all day. So, alrighty. Himmelsdorf. A lot of mediums on each side. I wish this tank had armor. It looks like it would be heavily armored, but it's just a paper mache tank. Really is paper mache. I'm not going to commit to the corner. The enemy team have way more meds than my team. We might be able to get a nice shot at the Panther. Wait, we just hit a wall. We're going to angle up our side here. That should bounce if he shoots at me. I was trying to really clutch a shot in towards that player. Looks like there's a CDC in front of us. Looks like there's a CDC AFK. Oh, that HE is good though. Yummy. Okay, so the whole enemy team here is here. My whole team is going towards D, as you can see, except for a few tanks, but it would be a really bad idea for me just to stay committed here because they have so many tanks coming this way, right? Instead, I think what I can do is I can just brain on their heavy tanks that are going to be kind of in the open. So we're going to put a shot in towards this ML1. And the KV-4 is going to be pretty isolated. I think... Oh, are you? Excuse me. Are you? You can pull behind me. There we go. I'm going to go brain on this KV-4. I think he's going to be crossing right about now. Oh, there's a CDC. I'm going to put an HE into him for 460. And this is where I'm going to get all of my damage farm from. Not the AFK CDC, from this KV-4. Although, I will get a lot of damage farm from the CDC. And you can see this gun is actually pretty decent. Are you? Please just stop running into me. Please. All right. We're going to aim for the KV-4's fuel tank. See, oh gosh, I accidentally scoped out. I am a bot. Okay, that's pretty cool. All right, well, we're just going to keep farming the KV-4 here because we have the penetration and alpha damage to do so. So KV-4 is still playing around here. I think our team's holding up on the other side pretty well. As long as they're holding up, that's all that matters, right? I'm going to wait till the KV-4 gives me his side. Then we're going to pop a shot in. And then we're just backing up here. We're going to try and bait him into shooting our turret, maybe. Oh, okay. Epic. All right, so here's what I'm going to do. I just disengaged my auto-aim there. You saw how it looked all the way away from the KV-4 before progressing? It's because my auto-aim would have kept track on him. So if you're in that kind of scenario, you have to disengage your auto-aim. And that's why I had to turn my gun away before aiming at the CDC. I know it sounds stupid, but that's one of the issues you have when it comes to playing with the auto-aim. So we're going to put another shot to the KV-4 here. We've done about 2,800 or so damage. If I can pick up kills, that will give me the ace, right? So I need to pick up kills. We're going to pick up a kill on the KV-4 probably. And if we can pick up a kill on the L1 and the SU, that's most likely what's going to get me the ace that I might... no. The RU is all the HP I was going to farm. Oh. We're going to go for the ML1 first, though. He's much more deadly. Going to put a shot into his tank there. And we're going to pull forward onto the SU as well. Going to get a nice little ramen on his tank there. And kill onto him as well. Alrighty. It's just the RU left. Gonna pop the adrenaline. Please don't run away from me into the... Please don't run into the enemy team. No, he's gonna get himself killed before I can kill him. No. Five kills might have gotten me the ace there. We were close. I don't know. we were first class. We were so close. I swear, if I had gotten the kill on the RU, that may have been an ace tanker. That was so close. We'll try one more time. One more time. And then it's back to TVP, because TVP is love. How much better do you play with 120 FPS? To be honest, a little bit better. It's more of a convenience than something that actually makes you play better. I know a ton of pro players and everything that play 60 FPS just fine. It's something that's nice to have, and it makes playing a little bit smoother sometimes, but for the most part, I don't think it's a necessity. It's just something that's nice to have. We're going to push on to the Type 59, aiming for those track shots. A lot of love those killer tracking shots. And because I tracked that Type 59, I'll be able to put a second shell into him. And that's why you should never underestimate the beauty of a track shot. In fact, his ammo rack is now out. So, yeah, he's not having a very good game, is he? Can we take his tracks off again? Not quite. There we go. Got to watch out for the T-34, but we've done good damage so far. We've done okay. This Type 59 is getting bullied by TVP. VTU, excellent. And I don't think there's much more for me to do here. Oh, no, that's a T-34. You're not getting damage on me, buddy. And there's a T-34-100. We do manage to bounce his shell there. And TVP's down low. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to drop low here. This will get me safe from their TVP while still allowing me to farm their VTU here, I think. Yeah, there we go. I'm going to push on to him. I think we're good. I think we got this. Now, the SU is an issue. Oh, gosh. What happened to my team? Oh, no. My whole team just blew up. That's not very nice. Oh no, there's a TVP VTU on me as well. Okay, I gotta cross to the corner. I gotta hold the corner here. The SU is on reload. I should be able to cross, thankfully. And we'll put another shot into this T49. Excellent. I have support from cover 5 from my team. There we go. Okay, we're now in a safe position. So if this T-44-100 pushes in on me, as I'm sure he will, he's going to meet the wrath of my entire team, which is not good for him. Good for me, not good for him. All right, T-44-100, we might be able to snipe a shot into the top of his turret there. Aye, not quite. Almost, almost. And we know where the SU is. I need to wait till the SU fires before I can really progress anywhere, because as long as the SU is staring at me and he's reloaded, there's really not much I can do here. Now, that is the Emil. I think we'll have a shot on him. Oh, there's the T-34. Ah, okay. You do have armor on this tank. Good to know. You know what? Ah, 10% battery. Okay, we still have time for more games, though. Oh, dear. Ah, 398G into the TVP there. We're doing okay. We're doing okay. We have about 2,700 damage here. This could be the ace game if we are not complete bots. Gotta try and bait a shot out of this dude. If I can bait a shot, then I can pick up a kill on him. All right, did the SU fire? I can't tell. I don't think he did. I don't have the gun depression. No. That's okay. Good job, T-32. All right, we're going to ignore the SU because this T-34 is probably going to come for me instead. Uh-huh. All right. Do you think we can cross? You think the SU is going to snap it? Hopefully he doesn't. Haha, he did not. All righty. So we can now work on this T-34 here. He's going to be right around the corner. Going to pop a nice shot into him. Okay. So this tank is capable of bouncing. Is it the best at bouncing? No, but it certainly can. I'm going to put another shot into the T-34 there. T-32, you got HP, my dude. Please take the shot. Let me have the kill now, actually. I need the ace. Hey! We're not doing too bad. We're not doing too bad. I need to stay alive. If I don't farm the SU, I'm not getting this ace. Farming the SU is my only hope. Oh wait, I can get shots on the Emil too, as well. Excellent. Or Emil 1. There we go. That's some damage I needed. No, SU, don't die. Don't die. Not yet. Die. You can die when I say you can. No. Pull back. No! I need to farm the SU. This is going to be a mastery first again. Calling it right now. But it's not going to be the ace. Not the infamous ace. Ah, we were so close. 3.6 and a mastery first class. Okay, we will get the ace eventually, but as we're on 10% sub 10% battery, I want to give you some more tier 10 gameplay before we are over 485 likes. You know what I'm going to ask for, right? Can we get 500? I think we can do it. I think there's some of you who have not hit that like button yet. So please, if you are enjoying the stream, smash that like button and let's get us to 500 likes. Alrighty, back in the TVP. Okay. It's not a bad map and not a bad matchup either. They have an M60, but other than that, it's mostly heavies and TDs. We can definitely deal with that. Wow, we passed 500 likes super fast. Oh my gosh, it happened in like 15 seconds. Oh my gosh, the fluctuations. Oh gosh, thank you guys, really appreciate it. Ay. Should not have taken that shot. Or that shot. Or that shot. Okay, well that one went through just fine. And that one does go through. There we go. Okay, two out of four. 50% pen ratio. I'll take that. Wow, that was very quick. Thank you, guys. Appreciate that. Alrighty, what are we going to do now? Well, there's an E5 over here. M60 crossed. I guarantee they have a bunch of TDs sitting above here. Speaking of which, there's the Jaeger Rue. We're going to aim for a track shot on him. One track shot, he's going to repair. We're going to track him again. He's going to repair that one as well. We're going to take his tracks off once more. And then we're going to hit him in the lower plate. Hopefully someone can pick up that kill now. Big brain, right? That's how it works. Even though I didn't get penned for that third shot that hit his tracks, because I was able to keep him in place. He used his repair kits, right? And then I penned his lower plate. And I knew these tanks, that tank over there, was going to reload in time to pick up the kill. So I take that. That was a very solid example of how you can utilize your clip to really just rip people apart with the tracking ability on this vehicle. All right, so there's a 4005 and a 268 over here. Don't necessarily want to poke a 4005. Roll 240. I'm going to put a second shot into him. He is running a small liner. I'm going to put a third shot into him. 260. Ay, low rolls. And it's just me, a Ho-Ri, and I think the 57 should do fine over there. So we're doing okay. We're doing okay. We should farm some good damage this game. Okay. What HP do you think the 252, the 4005's on? 420 max roll. Haha. Haha. Nice one, Wargaming. Very funny. We're going to put a shot into the 268. Going to load up a heat shell here. Can't quite pen that angle. I'm just going to reload my clip because I need to watch out for the 57. You can see the 57. He's coming in for me, right? He's going to deal a massive clip to me, which is not going to feel very good at all. So we're going to try and bait shots out of him first. I don't mind taking a clip from this 57 here because I kind of have to given the situation, but it definitely hurt. It's definitely going to hurt. Yeah. Yeah. That's 1, 2, 3. It's another shot into the 57. Unfortunately hitting his tracks there, hitting his tracks once more. And we're going to just run away from this 268 here. Hopefully he doesn't HE me. Does get the HE. It's whatever. I had to risk it. Our team should win this. No problem though. We have a huge map overmatch here. Ay, ay, ay. I was kind of hoping my team would come in and help me before I got YOLO'd, but it took them a few minutes to get over here. It's okay. We're still going to win in the end. The enemy team doesn't have the HP to win this. Yeah, our team should have this. Epic. All right. Well, just because we are cut for time, I'm not going to sit here watching my teammates. Let's jump right back into the Skoda T50. Where'd it go? Oh, it's whatever. I accidentally unmarked it. Alrighty. Alright, let's go. Mines. We all know how much I love mines. At least there's no 252Us on this time, on this map this time. Yeah, because 252Us last time really messed me up a lot. Okay. Let's get to 300 likes. Yeah, here we are, 522 likes. Thank you, guys. 550? We're gonna ask for it. We're gonna try and track the... Oh, wait. We're gonna track him. And he's dead, just like that. He's not gonna survive that. Epic. Nice. I decided I'll take a little bit more aggressively onto... What? Seriously? I'm gonna take a shot here, but I gotta get down. I can't believe their meds are gonna be sitting there all game. Oh, gosh. This is so classic. Medium takes giving up the hill. I mean, they have a crossfire on me for now. But in the end, they're going to lose this game because of this play. The medium tanks. The medium tanks are not winning the game with this play. Ay, 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 5% battery. Oh my gosh. If I die to this TI-2 because of that battery. Thank heavens for battery notifications. Oh my gosh. That completely threw me off. I was going to pick up a kill in the T-34 there. That's okay. Okay, wow, their meds are being super aggressive here. But they're not going to survive very long. Yeah. We should be able to pick up an easy kill onto this T-34-3 here. And it just leaves these other meds down low with our Waffenträger. RIP to the Waffenträger. He fought valiantly, but he had a lot of tanks jumping on him. We should be able to pick up a kill on the 54 here. That's one shot. That's two shots for the kill there. And it's just the T-92 who will probably want to push onto me, but I'm going to outspot him here. So I'm just going to spot him up, right? I am a one shot for the T-92, but at least I outspot him, right? So he can't push on me. Now, if our scent goes... Come on, just go, Scent. Just go. You got this. I believe in you. All I need is our Scent to push up here. Because the TI-2 is just looking at me. The Scent should have an easy kill, right? In fact, I'm going to pick up a shot onto the Emil. I think the Emil is a more deadly target here. So I'm going to put two shots into the Emil. And we're going to put three shells into that Emil. TI-2 is going to be a little bit distracted. He has just fired, and he fired at 11 seconds. Now, I know his tank has a 17-second reload, so I can now push in on towards this T-92, who's going to be on the long reload for quite a while. Not going to overextend, but I should be able to pick up this kill with HE. Excellent. And that leaves all of these tanks over here. Oh, no, that's a 110. That's not good. Okay, we're going to put one shot towards the 110. Not quite able to hit that one, but we should be able to put that one in. Excellent. Now, it's just me and this Scent. Enemy team... Oh, God, not hitting that 110 was really bad for me. Very unfortunate, because he would be a one shot right now, but unfortunately he's not, because I left him on 400 HP. If he was a one shot, then I could guarantee clip out the Emil 1, but the Emil 1's on 500 or so hit points as well. There we go. Able to get a really nice shot in there. I just need our Scent to kind of just big brain and push in on this dude. And then I need the Emil to overextend, trying to shoot at him. Okay, so one shot into the Emil. Get a really necessary bounce there. I'm just going to do suppression tactics here. Oh, thank heavens my shooting abilities are working right now. And come on, just poke forward. Excellent. There we go. It's just the Waffenträger left now. Might be able to get six kills. This should be an ace tanker if we win this battle. But as I'm a one-shot, I need to stay back. Heck, even the Scent Sunmark one's almost a one-shot. Question is, how do we play it out from here? I can easily kill this Waffenträger with HE. My bet is he's still in that bush, right? So I'm going to come all the way the long route towards him. I'm going to hope our Scent can take the hill. Right? The Waffenträger is probably in the bush. Now, he could be over there. Got to watch out for that. Okay. There's the Waffenträger. Oh, bad shot. It's okay. I still have 2 shells in the clip. That's all I need. It's 1 HE into him. I just need to put 1 more shot into him and the Scent should guarantee pick up the kill. Easy. There we go. I'm sorry if I was not doing a ton of commentary there. I was being super sweaty. I'm gonna wipe my hands off, actually. I don't know why that game had to be so intense. Oh, it should not have been that intense. Yay, we won the TVP game was an ace apparently as well, because this tank takes no experience to ace at all. Alright, battery, 2%. Okay, we're gonna run the tier 6. 2%. Do you believe we cannot die? Will we die? That is the real question. This is gonna be interesting. Stream ends on ace. Nice. Great final. You know what? That was a good game. Oh, no. Okay, I guess we're committing. We're committing. There's no going away from. There's no stopping. We got to do this. Okay. I am going to be as aggressive as I can physically be in this tank because, I have to be as aggressive as possible here. I really do. Because I only have about maximum two minutes of battery life here. Right? So I gotta be super aggressive on it. No, my team's not coming. Why are they going down? Okay, we're gonna go town. We're gonna big brain. Don't worry. Super aggressive mode has been activated. I am a Pog Light Tank. That's going to be the goal of today's game. Okay, we're gonna put 1 shot in towards this T25 too. He's gonna put a shot into me. We should be able to put a shot into him as well. And he did put a 3rd shell into us, but we both put 2 shots into each other. Okay, not bad, not bad. I think what I can definitely do from here, actually, is just keep running away. Yeah. So if T1 Heavy is pretty much ISO over there. If my battery dies, I am so sorry, team. I am really so sorry. I'm just going to believe in you as a team that you can win this. Although my faith is not super high right now. But we'll do our best. We'll do our best. Come on, battery. Don't die. Don't die. Aggression. Aggression. Full on aggression. No stopping. We got to do as much damage as possible. There's no passive gameplay here today. Come on, team. Oh my gosh, what's the reload on this dude's gun? Oh no. Okay, we might have been a little bit too aggressive, boys. Yes, yes. I'm going to bait them all into my team. This is perfect. Come on, team. I believe in you guys. Let's go. I only have like 1 minute left. We're fighting against time here. Okay. VK20A01. I'm going to put 3 shots into him. Uh-huh. Okay, we're still good on battery for a moment. Okay, that Skoda's gonna go for me from behind. Okay, okay. I think we got this. I think as a team, we've got this. We're on 23 hit points. This Chaffee's gonna YOLO in below. He's gonna try and shoot me, I'm sure. I would if I was him. Right? Right. Okay, we're gonna put 1 shot into the Chaffee, taking off his turret. We're gonna put a 2nd shot into the Chaffee. A little high explosive. Putting a 3rd shot into the Chaffee for a 500 clip there. Come on, team. I only have like 1 minute left on my game. I can't, honestly, I'm surprised my battery lasted about 2 minutes. I need to help my teammates. He's on my team. And we're done. Hey, we won the game. The important part is we won the game. I guess we really pushed the stream to the very edge of existence. Well, all that I can say is thank you so much to everyone who showed up for today's stream. I hope you all were able to learn a thing or two about the new Czechoslovakian medium tanks. As you can see, the tier 6 is Pog, the tier 9 is Pog, and the tier 10 is Pog. Tier 7 is decent, and of course the tier 8 is, it's okay. It's okay. But anyways, Yeah, I think that's it for me tonight. We've been streaming for about 3 hours, so a very, very solid stream. Once again, thank you so much to everyone who showed up. And of course, thank you to everyone who has donated to the channel. It really helps. And of course, thank you to CJ, Meezy, Economics Mate, Fidu, all of the mods that came on and moderated the chat here and kept it clean. And with that out of the way, I think I am heading off for the night. So take care, everyone. You guys.